All Atma Jyotis, Divine Light of the Self. I welcome one and all for this session of Atma Darshan Program 2020. This program I have been doing for many years now. Each year some many batches will go through this program. So over a period of time I have streamlined and standardized the method of teaching. The idea is to give an overview and understanding of the spirituality as taught by our spiritual masters, our gurus, in a way people can understand without bringing a lot of technical jargon, without bringing a lot of complexity. Bring a framework where people can, the idea is to take the message of a spiritual masters, gurus, to people. That's all. And this is a purely a non-commercial course. I'm not doing it for any profit. While I was working, I used to do it in weekends. So weekends, many classes I used to have. After retirement, I am taking it also during weekends because most of the people can participate during weekends only. So the program is called Atma Darshana Meditation Program. Okay, let me explain first. I'll explain this. Okay, before that, let us have a round up introduction. Now it's very difficult for each person introducing to me, right? I want you to know your names. And it will take time also. So what I request is introduce yourself to the next person. Just next person, adjacent person, introduce yourself. Okay. So then I'll ask some questions. Okay. Yes, please. So introduce yourself to the next person sitting. You can find that person. Okay. Yeah, people who are the people who are joining online, you can introduce through the WhatsApp message. you can just quickly say who are you and on the WhatsApp, that Atma Darshan group meditation OTP group, you can send who are you people, or rather Atma Darshan group. And all the people, I have sent the PPTs which I am using in the class on the WhatsApp already WhatsApp. I hope you have received it. The three PPTs I have sent.
Yes.
So, yeah, anybody wants to introduce from that online? Yeah, online also you can come and introduce yourself. You can unmute and introduce and mute again, please. Okay, may I request Smita to introduce?
Hello everyone, my name is Smita. I'm staying in Ebony. This is my very first self-discovery or a meditation program. So I'm really hoping that I will have a lot of takeaway from this. Thank you for this opportunity, Guruji.
Thank you, Smita. Welcome to the program. And may I speak, may I request Mr. R.L. Rao? Mr. R.L. Rao, sir, can you please introduce yourself? R.L. Rao is in mute.
Hello. Hello, sir. I am from Australia.
You are from Australia? You are joining from Australia?
No. I'm joining from Australia, but at the moment I'm in Australia.
Uh-huh.
And couple of months I'm going to back to Bangalore.
Oh, okay.
So because of that only I need to join.
Next online. Month in February I'm in Australia.
Okay.
Okay. Which part of Australia are you?
Melbourne. That is
Melbourne.
East Melbourne.
Oh, okay. Yeah, fine. Hopefully we'll meet sometime.
Okay, sir. Yeah, really. Okay.
May I request Yashmita to introduce yourself?
Yashmita.
Namaste, Guruji. I'm Yashmita. I had already attended the Atma Darshana class.
Okay.
I'm from Bangalore, actually.
Okay, welcome. Somebody has mentioned as Redmi. I don't know who is that. Can you please introduce yourself? Redmi must be Mamata's phone. Right? Phone right? Okay. Yes. I hope you people have introduced to you yourself, right? You did a good introduction. Okay. Some shake hands. Some. Who is joined?
Sheetal
Kulkarni. May I request Sheetal Kulkarni to introduce yourself?
Hello, Guruji. I'm Sheetal Kulkarni. I'm from Bangalore. Okay. And I have been a very avid listener. And I mean, I'm a very, I follow you from past a few months. Uh-huh. I have listened to many of your Atma Darshana and Drik Drishya Viveka, everything. And I like, and I am able to connect to you so much. That's why it feels great to be with you today.
Very nice. Welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Then Satyavati has joined. It must be our Satyavati. Satyavati, can you introduce yourself? Good.
Hariyom Guruji.
Hariyom Satyavati.
I am Atmajyoti Satyavati and I have been a follower of Advaita teachings by our beloved Guruji from the past 4 years.
Okay.
I am from Bangalore.
Very welcome.
Thank you.
So, one round of introduction is over. I'll introduce myself. My name is Narasimha Prabhu. Okay, my name which my father had given. I'm married. I have 2 daughters. One daughter is stays in Rajarajeshwari, and other daughter is studying in USA. I had a deep interest in this subject of spirituality since childhood. Because of various exposure from my friends and teachers and gurus, masters. So the exposure runs into many different dimensions in terms of yoga. Initially, had a very good foundation of yoga for many years as a young kid. Then Vedanta in terms of Advaita Vedanta. Okay, but I would not call myself as a scholar. Okay. Whatever I am teaching is based on a little bit of spiritual practice which I do at the after working hours, night, weekends. So meditation, contemplation. So most of my time goes into meditation, contemplation. So from that I gain some insight. And from masters I learned many things. And just as a respect for my masters, I want to share whatever I learned with the people so that whatever the masters have given to me, it goes to some more people. So that they will pass on to some more people. There is no other expectation. Okay? The idea of Indian system of spirituality is so valuable, so important. Unfortunately, we don't have a good exposure because, you know, schooling system or anywhere. So this is a way of communicating that in an informal way to the best of my ability. Okay? I don't want to call myself as an expert or master. I will just say whatever I know, whatever I understood, I am passing it on. Okay, that many people have benefited over a period of time. Many people have found peace in life because of this teaching. So you are also welcome to explore. Okay. And people call me Guruji, Prabhuji, a friend, whatever is that. I worked in the IT industry for 30 years. Okay. So I come from an intensely technical background with the master's from IIT Bombay. And work in mostly in telecom R&D and software, worked in many companies. So I understand the problem of a modern day life very well, right? Being working in IT industry gives you enough exposure to life. Then being a householder has a good exposure to life. Having being a parent of 2 daughters also is a good amount of responsibility. So from that perspective, yeah. from that perspective, I'm able to come give you insights into life based on spiritual teachings and hardcore experience of life, where I'm baked in life. Ultimately, the spirituality cannot stand without life. Okay, the spirituality is like people think that spirituality means going somewhere and studying somewhere, doing something. It has to be learned in the laboratory of life. Okay, outside you cannot learn. In the laboratory of life, when you learn, you are able to apply it. So that probably that is one qualification which I have. Okay, let us start. Let's start with Omkara three times. I'll chant, then you join. ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
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 ओम नमः शिवाय
ॐ नमः शिवाय
ॐ नमः शिवाय
ॐ नमः शिवाय ॐ नमः शिवाय
लेट अस स्टार्ट टुडेस सेशन सो दिस विल बी अ सेट ऑफ कॉन्टेम्प्लेशंस व्हाट आई कॉल इज आत्मविचार आई विल आस्क क्वेश्चंस ओके इट इज अल्टीमेटली इट विल बी मीनिंगफुल व्हेन यू पार्टिसिपेट इट्स नॉट देयर इज In this class, there's not much of teaching. Okay, there's much of participation. There's much more of interactions. Okay, so and also one word for people who are on online. You can always whenever the interaction is there, you can just come online because you may not be able to hear what people are speaking here. Okay, I don't know how to link people are speaking there.
Most of them, Guruji, are able to hear because this microphone is sensitive enough.
Okay. Fine, let us try it out. Okay, so those who came late, bit late, right? I request you to introduce to next person sitting. Introduce yourself to next person. Just introduce yourself. Okay, just get an introduction. Anybody who came late? Yeah, you can just. Screen doesn't.
Want to share
the screen? Yeah, no, the screen was not able to change. How do I
go to the next slide? Please.
Yeah.
Because the slide is coming. Yeah.
How do I go to the next slide? Yes. All right. Yeah. Yeah. So, and just to give a quick introduction about myself, I told about myself. Okay. This method, this teaching program is called Atma Darshana Meditation Progress. So Atma Darshana means to see yourself, okay? To know yourself. Why do you want to know yourself? I'll find out. We'll find out. To know yourself is the program. You may ask a question, why do I have to come here to know myself? My husband knows me better or my daughter knows me better. I know myself better, okay? Yeah, but there is something, actually a lot of secrets about you are here in this place. So you can know something more about you in this place. And this involves a set of practices called meditation practices, which you have to practice at home. I'll give one round of introduction here, then you practice at home. And self set of question answers, which is interactions, which will open up something in you. Okay? Something about you, which you would not have recognized earlier. Now, how does this come? It doesn't come from Prabhu, me, these questions. These questions are based on the teaching of Rishis. Of India. There are a lot of rishis in India. So they have said most important thing in life is to have Atmadarshana, know yourself. And for that, they have given a teaching in terms of so many spiritual teachings, in terms of Upanishads, in terms of Vedanta, in terms of many subjects. Okay. It's a vast. In fact, it's like an ocean. You cannot touch it. Okay? It is too big. Okay. It requires understanding of Sanskrit, understanding of their context. Right? So, then, fortunately for us, Sri Ramana Maharshi came in this century. He simplified entire teaching of Upanishad and Vedanta into one question. Who am I? Who am I is the question. Just one question. So he said, the entire Vedas, you may not have to worry. Okay, I didn't study Rig Veda, I didn't study Yajurveda, I didn't study Sama Veda. It's so big. Vedas are sacred. I didn't study Bhagavad Gita. He said, one question, if you find out the answer, who am I? You have understood all those. Okay. But is it easy to find a question of answer to who am I is the question. Right? So for that, it requires a guidance of a person who has gone through this. Okay. So that your learning becomes easier. Right? Anything in our life, it becomes easier when somebody has learned it, can pass it on. For example, cooking, when you start learning, your mother's 20 years, 30 years of experience of cooking will be taught to you. Okay. So it is complex if you start from elbow, start scratch. If somebody is able to teach you from step by step, he'll simplify the matter. Ultimately, it is you have to use it. Okay. I cannot help it. I can only give you the food. You have to eat it. But I can give you food in the way it's cooked and edible form. That's all I can contribute. Is it okay? So the teaching comes from Upanishads, Vedanta, Bhagavad Gita, and Ramana Maharshi. And this teaching methodology, there are a variety of methods of teaching. Okay, this teaching method is called direct path. Okay, what is direct path? I'll tell you later. The direct path teaching will focus on the truth directly rather than going in an indirect way. Whereas there are so many paths, Bhakti Marga, your Karma Marga, Kriya Marga, they are all called progressive paths, step by step. Here the focus is on direct path. Okay? The direct path teaching was there from thousands of years in India, but it was lost. It was recovered by Sri Ramana Maharshi, Sri Nisargadatta Maharaj, Sri Atmananda Krishna Menon. These are the three people who pioneered it. I'm just trying to pass it on, whatever I've learned from them, you people. Is that clear? So you don't have to think it is coming from this man. I have tried to, whatever message of masters, so spiritual masters, I am passing on. You can think I am just a instrument. Okay. One of the things, this instrument is a little bit not just an ordinary instrument, it has tried out a lot of things and found out, okay, so what are things works out. Okay. So this set of practices, it involves some meditation. Now you have heard of meditation is very popular. So pay some fees and do some meditation. Okay. What people don't understand, that meditation is two types. It's called, one is called dhyana or meditation and called nididhyasa. Okay. They are different. Dhyana and nididhyasa are not same. Okay. So dhyana means focus on an object. Okay. For example, I'll say focus on Shiva. You think of, imagine Shiva. Okay, focus on Krishna. You imagine Krishna. So Krishna is an object there. Okay, focus on breath is an object. Okay. So that's called dhyana. Whereas nididhyasa is not focusing on the object. It's focusing on the subject. Focusing on I. Why you have to focus on I? Because I is called God. I is God. Whatever you see is only image of God, okay? But one who sees it is God. One who sees through your eyes and hears through your ears is God. You understand? So in the direct path approach, you're directly going to God or the self. God and the self means same thing. Why it is called self? Because one who sees through my eyes, I think I am. In reality, I am just an instrument. The seer is God. Okay. So the approach of Atma Darshan meditation program is go towards this self. That's called Nididhyasa. Nididhyasa is very different from Dhyana. But I'll be teaching you Dhyana also and Nididhyasa also. The reason is simple. Many people require some focus. The Dhyana gives some good amount of focus. Then you will be ready for Nididhyasa. So there will be a mix of Dhyana, Nididhyasa and a set of question answers. These question answers are called prakriyas. These are methods. Okay. A prakriya is what you call as a procedure. A kriya means a procedure. A systematic way of asking a question which will open up something in you is called a prakriya. Okay. In a modern language, you can say, you can call it as a surgery. Okay, prakriya can be done only here. Okay, meditation can be taught here. But when you go home, okay, you can do practice meditation. Prakriya is only in front of the guru or master can happen. Is the difference clear? Okay. What is the necessity of prakriya? Prakriya is because all our problems in the world are because of the mind. Okay. Mind is the cause of problems. Not only for myself, for others also. A prakriya is systematically exposing the lies told by the mind. Falsehood told by the mind. Mind is the thief. Okay. A thief requires a questioning by a policeman. Then when you question, the thief will become silent. So the mind is actually telling a lot of lies to you, falsehood to you. The purpose of a prakriya here is to expose the lies which your mind is telling. When the lies are exposed, the mind becomes silent. And when the mind becomes silent, the Atma or the God only is there. So that is the process. See, why normally meditation doesn't work is because meditation is focused on the mind. Okay. Whereas Atma Darshan is focused on going beyond the mind. Meditation, I practice meditation for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. You are practicing in the mind, which is a thief. You have to catch the thief. Then only you have to go beyond mind. Okay. That is the process of Atma Darshan. Any questions? Are you clear? Any questions for anybody? Can I proceed? Sir, any questions for you? What's your name? Guru Prasad. Any questions for you? Or your name?
Manoj.
Anybody else? Okay, can I proceed? So now, over the years, there are a lot of support materials built on the internet. Okay. So this is non-commercial. All we do is homemade. So I come and some students of mine record and somebody does a transcription. So material is available put on the internet for public use. There's nothing secret in this. Everything is open. Okay. But a lot of work has been done. So for example, Gayatri comes and takes all audios and videos, posts it for the group, for the public. This whole thing is not a secret. It's all open. Okay. The idea is anybody from anywhere in the world should be able to access it. The idea is not myself, okay? I'm not building an organization. The idea is the message of Rishis has to reach to people. That's all. So my only request for you people, I don't have any expectation because no money is not required because God has given for me what is required. And this is not an organization where there's no administration, nothing. It is just that teaching and it reaches people. So if you feel it's useful, you pass it on to somebody else. If you feel you can teach to somebody, you teach. The idea is the message of Rishis has to go. That's all. Nothing else. Is the expectation. Okay. So more and more youngsters in India should get exposed to the spiritual teachings of the masters, which is a great teaching, and we are missing it because of our various social conditioning. Okay. So there is a YouTube link, right? These things are available, and you can refer to in your PPT extent. Then there's a Facebook page. WhatsApp group is called, whatever WhatsApp group is there, you have to send a message to that. It's called Sadhguru Teaching. Every day I post about 10 to 12 messages. They are actually triggering you for thinking. Okay, the idea is it's not a teaching. Teaching of Ramana Maharshi, Nisargadatta Maharaj, all those things. You may not understand initially, but gradually start understanding. You should think about that, then start something opens up in you. So that I do 10 to 12 times a day, because I want you to be people, think of God, think of self all the time. You'll get lost in the homework. Home. So now, the way, best way to catch you is through WhatsApp. Because we are so addicted to WhatsApp, at least see this message, think of it. Okay, so you can subscribe to that subgroup teaching. Those who are in Telegram can subscribe to that link. Then they say available on Gmail. Okay, and then there is an app which is called engagepower.com, which is done designed by Vijayji. So the idea in the app is the lot of Atmashan program people can before coming to the class they can go through it, and here they can ask more questions. I can spend more time on question answer rather than talking. But today being the first class, you download this app and go through, start going through the lessons. Is it clear? Okay, and it is all done in a, I know your difficulties. I know our attention span, 10 minutes, 5 minutes type of videos. It's not half an hour, 45 minutes. Okay. So, because I come from a householder, I'm a householder, I'm a grahastha, I know the challenges. So we make it simple and try to contemplate. The idea is to this Atma Darshana, you are a wife, full-time wife, right? You are a husband, full-time husband. You are an employee, full-time employee. But if you are dedicated to God, you have to be full-time God. God dedication. God is not a part-time activity. But how to do it part-time without affecting our full-day activity is what we are trying. Okay? We don't have to become go to a monk and ashram to do something. How to integrate God in our life full time is the effort. Okay, so you can use those apps. Now, when I spoke to you, introduce yourself. You give an introduction. Did you tell your name? Did you tell your profession? Age? Are you your biodata? So my question is, sir, are you your biodata? Biodata is useful, okay? Right? For getting a job, it's useful. Okay? Biodata is very useful. For marriage purpose, biodata is quite useful. Put a nice photo, marriage purpose. But for spiritual purpose, biodata is useless. Question is, are you your biodata? Okay? Please think over. Do you think are you a biodata? Suppose your name, right? You tell your name, right? Introduce yourself, you tell your name. You can change your name, but you don't change. Right? You say, I have a job. That job can change. You can, job can disappear. I am a man or woman, you can say, right? That doesn't change that easily. But nowadays, that also changes. Okay. So, are you your biodata, madam? Huh? But all the time, we live as if we are our biodata. Right? We think we are biodata. Do you?
That's how we are used to.
That you are how you are used to. What is the problem of being a biodata? Please tell me. Is there a problem in being a biodata? What is the problem?
Always we focus on self-appraisal rather than listening.
Ah. Okay. I don't know if you've heard of a story, okay? The story. When the problem of being a biodata is a story. There's a story. One top engineer, it is a real story happened. Topper from IIT Madras. Okay. Masters and PhD from top American university. Employed in the best of the jobs in America. Married with two children. And having the 5-bedroom house in the best locality in America. One day he comes and takes a gun and shoots himself. Shoots the children and the family member. Okay. Then, what happened, the California psychiatrist, they did a study on him. Okay. The study says, Right from the school days, he was a topper, rank holder. Okay. PhD also, top job also. One day, the company where he was working was purchased by some other company. And they removed from this guy from the company. And for 5 months, he was not able to pay that monthly EMI of the house. And he was not able to tolerate that, humiliation. He shot himself. And the psychiatrist concluded, what is his problem? Peri, can you please tell me what is his problem? Listening to the story?
He has faced failure.
Yes?
Failure.
He has become his biodata.
Yes, he's identified himself.
He has completely his biodata. He is not a human being. Okay, he has become his biodata. Okay, in biodata there is a failure, job is gone. Are you your biodata? Are you living yourself as biodata? Are you teaching your children as biodata? Huh? Please imagine what will happen to your children when they become biodata. You have to teach your children how to live life. Biodata is required for making a living, but living life, live life is what you are. Is that clear at all? You don't have to agree with me, okay? This can be discussion, right? If you don't agree with me, you can always disagree, right? And many times when you become biodata, there's misery in life. Open any newspaper after SLC exam. So many children kill themselves, okay? Why? Not because they failed. Instead of 97 marks, 95 marks I got. Okay? People get into depression because you are taught to become your biodata. Please understand, you are not your biodata. Okay? First wrong understanding you have to remove from your mind that I am not biodata. Biodata, I have biodata. Okay, biodata can change, but nothing happens to me. Right? We are teaching our children continuously improve your biodata and become the biodata. We have to teach the children continuously improve the biodata, but don't become biodata. Are you doing that? Okay. So, any question for people who are on the remote session? Do you people agree?
Yes, Guruji.
Okay. If you don't agree also, you can come and tell. Okay. I don't think I am right. Okay. I know a little bit. You can always say, no, this is the way it is. We have a biodata, but we are not the biodata. Anything in the biodata is not you. You have it. Tomorrow you don't have a job. Okay. Today you are beautiful, beauty and handsome. Tomorrow you don't have. So now there are three aspects of me. Okay. How many are you? Three. Okay. First is what I think I am. And second is what others think I am. And third is what really I am. Now, you can talk. I know you people can talk very well for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. What about I am? Okay. What other people think of I am? You can think. Now, to your neighbor, just tell what you are really. One line. Not even more than one line. What you think you are and what others think you are is a biodata. What you are really, okay? Can you please tell to others, neighbors, what are you really?
I'm bliss.
Okay. What about you? Huh? You are good. That is what you think you are. Your mother thinks you are not here. She is not, you know. Right? So, see, what we think we are and what we are, there's a difference. Are you good all the time? Sure. I know when you are not good. See, what we are is what we say to ourselves. Okay. But what we are doesn't change. What is that? Yes, madam. Tell something about yourself. No, I asked you, tell, introduce yourself. I didn't ask you your biodata. I didn't ask you about what you think yourself. Madam, can you tell something about yourself? What you are? Guru Prasad, sir? What you are? That is what you have, a profession, right? Are you able to distinguish between what I am and what I have? I have a job and a profession, it's called software engineering. But what I am?
Whatever I can think of falls under the first and second.
Okay, in this class, first thing you learn, okay, to distinguish between what you are and what you have. Okay, you have to ask the question, what I have and what you are. What you have can dissipate at any time, but what you are will never change. Is the distinction clear? Sir, software engineering profession is permanently what you have? Huh? Software engineer has a shelf life, no? After that, what? Retired engineer. Right? So, software engineer is what you have. What you are. We'll find out that human being part also. See, this whole course, this whole class is about what you are. I'm not interested in what who you are. I'm not interested in, we are not interested in what you think yourself as and what society thinks of you. There is no interest in this class. Okay? What society thinks of you and how to improve it, you have to go to a human resource consultant. HR consultant. Oh, you are there. Okay, what you are is the only focus of this class. And how come you are 40 years, 50 years old and you don't know what you are? Huh? And, you know so many things, right? Huh? You can talk hours together on a movie, hours together on politics, and hours together on the film actors. Life, not in his life. Huh? Tell me one line about what you are. Huh? And after 40 years or 50 years, what are you doing in life? Tell me. How old are you? These people are young, okay? They are exposing, getting exposed earlier. Huh? What are you?
I am in third standard.
That is cool. That's what you do. Right? I didn't ask what you do, right? I am asking what are you? Now in this year, third standard, next year, fourth standard, next fifth year standard. Like, what are you? Who are you?
I'm Namit.
Namit is your name. Mommy, daddy called you Namit. Another mommy, daddy, if mommy, the mommy, daddy had a name called Namit, they had a second thought, they would call you Ram. Shivaram, the name. For name is for whom?
For me.
Who is that me? Do you understand? Name is given to somebody. Who is that somebody? Name is a label. Okay. Name is not what you are. Name is a way of showing. Do you understand? Who are you?
Not the name.
You are not the name. That's very clear.
Okay. So here, the challenge of spirituality is you cannot tell who you are, because that you have to recognize. Okay. I cannot tell you. I can only help you to find out who you are not. This class is about not. This class is about telling you who you are not. Okay. Mm-hmm. Nobody can tell you who you are. Ultimately, you have to recognize, and our Vedanta, our spiritual, this was Vedas, Upanishads say, if you recognize who you are, then you are done in life. Okay. That is the ultimate in life. If you recognize who you are. In this class, I can only help you to recognize who you are not and point out who you are. Okay. But I cannot show you who you are. It is you who have to recognize who you are based on my inputs. And where does the input come from? Teaching of Vedanta Upanishad. Now you'll ask me, what is the benefit of this? What is the benefit of knowing who I am? Right? What is the benefit? What is the benefit of knowing who am I?
No suffering, Ananda.
Who, what you are not, or what you have, can change anytime. What you are will never change. And that is ultimate peace. So meditation doesn't give peace. Okay, please understand. People think that meditation gives peace. Meditation doesn't give peace. Knowing who you are gives peace. Meditation is only a technique, a tool. I will practice meditation for 10,000 hours. You will not go anywhere because you are not addressed the question who you are. Understand? Okay, so you may see many people practicing this spirituality, that spirituality, many, many years. But the progress doesn't happen because the meditation is just a technique. The technique doesn't lead to who you are. The questioning leads to who you are. By dropping who you are not. Then once you recognize who you are, the mind becomes peaceful. Then though meditation is required, that's called nididhyasa. So please tell, understand the definition of nididhyasa. Nididhyasa means not doing anything, not seeking anything, okay? Just being very peaceful. Just being. Okay, I get happiness by eating coffee, going to movie. I get happiness by doing something. Meditation is just being, you feel so blissful and peaceful, not doing anything else, not even meditation. That is called nididhyasa. The purpose of this is to teach you nididhyasa, but I'll take you through self-inquiry and what you call as nididhyasa practices. But it will take some 8 to 9 months, and you need to put your effort in homework. Okay? Now let us do something, one thing. Okay? We'll sit silently for some time. Don't do anything. Do nothing. Seek nothing, just be. Okay? What is the question? Just be. And then after, just 5 minutes, not more than that. Okay? I know how much torture to sit, be yourself. Just be yourself for 5 minutes. Okay? So let us sit for silently for 5 minutes. Just be. And don't, no chanting of mantra. No chanting of mantra, japa, anything, nothing. No take, don't support anything. Just be yourself. No. Imagine this imagination. Then you are in something else. Just be yourself, not with anything. Are we clear? Close your eyes. Let us 5 minutes. Let us be, just be ourselves.
Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amritam gamaya om shanti shanti shanti
om shanti shanti
lokaah samastaah
sukino bhavantu
lokaah samastaah
sukino
bhavantu
lokaah
samastaah
sukino
bhavantu harihi om
shri
gurubhyo namah
harihi om
So, how easy or how difficult is it to sit silently by yourself, not doing anything? Are you able to do? What happened?
I was just concentrating here.
Yeah.
Because I don't want anything to come.
Yeah.
The picture.
Okay.
But it is
really difficult. Okay.
Anybody else? Yeah, the mind trips.
Mind trips.
Yeah. So, trips as a whatever I did. I had two classes in the morning and something important.
What?
Something or the other keeps the head. Wasn't like it was blind.
Yeah. Same thing what she said. When you close your eyes, you get the list of things which are
supposed to do.
But she said focusing at the center of good eyes helps.
Yeah. The focusing on the center is called dhyana. Okay? So here when you be yourself, your dhyana has to be dropped. Because the reason is focusing on yourself, mind is trying to focus. Okay? The gradually we should drop the dependence on the mind. Okay? The reason is simple. There are many circumstances in life where we cannot rely on the mind. We should become free from the grip of the mind also, gradually. That's called Nididhyas. We'll do it. Guru Prasad? It is thought. Thoughts will come, right? Okay. But then what will happen? You are bringing somebody other than yourself. It is okay. They are all part of the dhyana. But gradually, you should come to the pure self. Right? Initially,
What is that? What aspect of self?
Up to 50 years of your life, you are not discovered. You don't even know about it. Now only you are started. That is called God. That's called self, the pure self. Okay, how is that? It's just we are started, beginning the journey. Right? This question didn't even come to you till date. So this is actually real spiritual journey. When you start understand there's something there, you start going to that. It won't be smooth because you have spent your 40 or 50 years of life in the others. But a path will open up. Okay. So, what did you? You are able to sit silently.
Initially, there was a distraction. Then slowly, I focused on my breathing.
See, that is you are focusing on the breathing. That's called dhyana. Breathing is not yourself. One day, breath will stop, ma. Huh? Do guarantee that breath will be there all the time. Breath will be there as long as the body is pumping. But there will be day when there will be no breath also. That time also, are you be peaceful? So that you have to be ready now. Whatever you have, whatever you know, will be not be there. But then what will be there is the only thing which can be there. And that's called God. That's called yourself. Okay. Right now, that's the most neglected thing in the world today. Everything else we have time. We don't have time for the self. Okay. Self is not an object at all.
not a breath, not an image, nothing, the pure self. And the pure self is called God. To be with yourself means to be with God. So how religious you are, how spiritual you are, is determined by, not by the dress you wear, not by the puja you do, but ultimately, are you able to sit by yourself, with yourself, not doing anything, not seeking anything? That is called mukti. Okay? You understand? So, is it difficult? Not difficult. Provided you understand so much of Vedanta, scriptures and all, it's a lot of study. Now, it's too difficult. So, what I've done is I've tried to extract the cream out of that and try to give you inputs on that so that you can apply it in your life. By yourself, it will take a lot of money. I have spent a lot of many years on that, struggling through those. So, essence of that, I'm trying to give it to you. So, don't be under the, it's so difficult, don't understand. Right? You people have a headache. Any of you have a headache? You take a tablet? No tablet for headache? Okay, fever? Crocin tablet you take? Huh? Right? How much Crocin tablet costs?
Two rupees,
no? Cheap, no? You tell me what is the content of the Crocin tablet, what is the chemical in that, what is the molecule in that? You don't know. Why? That medicine, you just, your disease, your problem is disease, fever. Take the medicine, you go over. But the 2 rupees Crocin tablet to get, billions of dollars of research has gone. You don't have to spend so much of billions of dollars. 10,000 scientists have worked. You don't have to work. Similarly, thousands of rishis in India have already done the research. Okay. To solve the human problem. And they have created into some simple methods. I start by Ramana Vashu, who am I? Enquiry. All that you have to take is the 2 rupees tablet. You don't have to do so much of research. I will do my research. It will take so much of time. So, what is then? I am trying to give you the tablet. Whatever they have discovered, I am trying to. I also got the tablet. I am also passing on the tablet to you people. Is it clear? Don't be under the sheet. It's so difficult. It's difficult if you start from the scratch. Okay. It's difficult if you don't know the what medicine. Paracetamol. Crocin, you take brufen or something like that. It will not, disease will not work. Only Atma Dana, only method will work is self inquiry. After thousands of years, finally it is the only method which is the works. So take it properly, it will be free. Okay. So I am not my biodata. Is it anybody has a doubt? Right? What I am really. So what, why you are not biodata, I'll tell you. Okay, whatever you are not, you'll be uncomfortable all the time. Tell me who is comfortable in this job. So many industries here, you are working in the industry, software industry, you know, India industry. Tell me who is comfortable with the job. I love my job. I am very comfortable with my job. Huh? The moment you say I'm comfortable, the boss will come and say, oh, what the hell, appraisal time. So biodata is not you. I am comfortable as a wife or a husband. That's the most uncomfortable position. That's the least I know. Am I comfortable as mother? There are roles. Okay. But ultimately, there'll be uncomfortable. Come, what you are not, you'll uncomfortable. But what you are, will never be uncomfortable. Understand? If you are able to recognize what I am really in this life and I'm alive, then you have made your life. That is the purpose of life as per the Veda, Vedanta, Upanishads. Otherwise, you will take another birth to become comfortable. It will take birth after birth to become comfortable. So that's called Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam, Punarapi Janani, Chatare Shayanam, Iha Samsare, Bhudusare, Krapaya Pare, Pahi Murare, Pahi Murare. The only purpose we take repeated births is to find out who am I. Better get it done once for all. because unless I find who am I, I'll not be comfortable. Anything else will be not be comfortable in life. It'll be restless. And to avoid restlessness, what all things you do in life? Please tell me. What did you try to, when you get, let's say, free time of 4 hours, what did you, how did you spend your free time of 4 hours in life? Tell me. Huh? Video games, watching movie, WhatsApp,
playing.
Huh? And people become workaholics. Somebody says, you're so hard working, he works for 18 hours a day. Why? Because he is not able to sit by himself peacefully. He is not so restless. Not because he loves the work job. You understand? My dear, learn to be peaceful by yourself. Then you do whatever you want. That's all is this class. Okay? I cannot guarantee that you will become peaceful. Okay? There's no commitment here. I can only show what are the steps involved in that. Then you say after the end of the class, 9 months, I am not peaceful. I only say... This is why you are not peaceful, I can show you. Then why you are, how to become peaceful, you have to find out. Okay, now who said I am a human being? Ah, my dear. What makes you a human being? Emotions, monkeys also have. Animals have emotions, you've seen, you know? Emotions, I don't think it's very peculiar for you. What makes human being? Can you please tell me? Anybody? One by one. First, what makes human being? What makes you human being?
Probably the way I am physically, with my hands, this thing.
Oh, that makes you human. What makes human being?
Behavior.
Huh? Behavior. Animals are much more behaved, you know. You see how many human beings are worse than animals? Huh? I'm not saying you as a human being. As a makes, what makes a human being? You see how animals, human beings treat. No animal will treat another animal like that. Human beings treat human beings other than more than worse than animals. What makes a human being? See, these are basic questions, okay? It's a question, is it a time to ask questions at the age of 50 years, what makes a human being? We are taking it for granted, I'm a human being. What makes a human being, sir?
Treating other human beings with
dignity. No, don't say you. I'm saying in general, right? There are human beings who treat other human beings like animals, or worse than animals. But they still be called as human beings. What makes a human being? Sir, dolphins are much sharper than human animals. Many of the animals are much sharper than human beings in thinking. Okay, we can create something out of that. It's okay. But why I am human? Why anybody is called a human being? Tell me. Okay. So now this human being is a very peculiar word. It has two parts. Human plus being. All what you have said is about human part. Tell me something about being part. Tell me something about being part, my dear. Little bit of some being. Okay. Little bit, tell me about human being part. Consciousness. Kindness is human part. Animals are also very kind. In fact, animals are more kinder than human beings.
Yeah.
Human beings are ruthless.
Viveka.
Yeah, somebody is speaking. Can you please tell me?
Uma?
Hello? Uma, you are trying to tell something? No, she's not listening. Okay. Can you tell me what makes a human? What makes a human being? See, in this class, only basic questions are asked. Okay. Whatever most of the people think is taken for granted, those questions will be asked. being? What means human being? Yeah, please. Can you forget the chat? How do you scroll?
Chat besides share screen.
So, yeah, anybody online can have a question, can ask what makes a human being? Okay. Answer. All of you have scientists, engineers, doctors.
The ability to improve state. Others are born as born, while humans.
Okay, human beings have to improve their condition of life. What are you improve, sir? You can improve your condition. You can go by a flight. You can go by the moon. But can you improve your mind? Become more peaceful. Many of the animals are more peaceful than human beings. In the 20th century, okay, you know what is the maximum number, the largest disease which is affecting human beings on the 20th century? Depression is the largest disease affecting human beings. Okay. I have not heard of any animal being depressed except some dogs which are living with a depressed human being. Dogs, only domestic dogs.
Oh,
otherwise, dogs don't have depression. Who is in a better condition, tell me? Dogs' life, the animal life is tougher. But no animal goes through depression. Except domesticated animals like dogs and cats. They learn depression from human beings. So, is it the ability to improve our life? Is it,
is it because that's kind of being as while we are like trying to figure out.
Okay, let us, the human being, again the word I pointed out, there are two parts to word, human being. The being part we are not speaking of. Okay, we talk a lot about human part. Right? Now let us talk about what is this human being part. Okay, let me see. I want to change slide. Let me just open this slide. Yes. Okay, I got to screen share now. Yeah, you can share. Okay. So this is what makes a human part. This is the left side, what makes a human part, what you call as human being. Having one kidney, one liver, okay, a shape of the body. If you have some different shape of the body, you will become animal being, a monkey being. But being is what I am interested in. This class is about being, not about human part. Right? A human being is a body, mind, intellect, energy, all those things is what you see as a body. This is the interface. Okay. And what about being? What is this being all about? Have you thought of what is this being business? Human being, what we use left and right. Being is it, a human being is two words, no? Human being. Is being 50% of human and 50% you are 50% human and 50% being? What are you? 50-50, 20-30, 40-60? You would answer the question because you started with human being. How much percentage you are being and how much percentage you are human? What is 90? Oh, she says 90 human and 10 being. Okay, anybody else has any other opinion? 70-30. Okay. Madam, what about you? Good.
Mostly human.
Then what do you do? This class is about being. It is not about human at all. Okay. I'll tell you what is human being. Okay. You understand. Somebody dies in the house. Right? And what do you do with that person? Dispose of in the best possible way. Burn or bury. The human part is there. The being part is not there. Now what are you? Human part or being part? if it's human part is there, lying there. If you want to preserve the human part, you can put in a refrigerator and do something. But human part is there. But being part is not there. Then what do you do with that thing? Then how much you are human, how much you are being?
70% of human and 30% of being.
No. If 70% human, if somebody dies, that body has to be kept in home. Human part is lying there only. But where you go and burn it?
100% being.
100% you are being. 0% you are human. What is it? See, if it is a human part is there, and you put an injection or some medicine and some refrigerator, you keep the human part in the house. No, you don't do that. You want to throw out the human part because human part is the disease, kidney, liver, body, and actually you remove whatever is possible and throw it out. Right? So what you don't recognize that you are the being, you're just using human. Do you understand what I'm saying? It is actually you are 100% being, using the human part and confusing that you are a human when you are a being. You understand what I'm saying? You are being, using human part to communicate, interact, have children, marry, or whatever is that. The human part is the instrument, where a being part is what you are. So you are so addicted to the instrument, like you are addicted to mobile phone or TV. Now you become this mobile phone and TV. So this class is again and again making you remember that you are the being, not the human. Okay. The being is called in Sanskrit, it's called Atma. The being is called Bhagavan, God, a part or equivalent of God. So this class is again and again remembering I am the being is using human.
Yes, sir.
What is the nature of being? There is a presence, there is a consciousness. Right? The consciousness which is animating you, making you alive, making you means the body mind alive, is human. The consciousness goes, the body is gone. It's dead matter. So you are giving life to the dead matter called body. In body, what is there, my dear? All chemicals. It's a chemical factory. Okay? And the consciousness goes, that chemical factory will start rotting. You can't keep it for 4 hours. You are the one who is giving life to that chemical factory called body. So now tell me, which is the most important part of your body? Eyes, ears, nose. Consciousness. And what is the most neglected part of you?
Consciousness.
Are you getting what I'm saying? Have you in your 50 years of lifetime, can you give 5 seconds to consciousness? And consciousness is called God. You do puja for God, but you not understood what is that. You do a lot of puja, prasadam, naivedyam, everything you do. And consciousness is called God. In Sanatana Dharma, we call Pradnanam Brahma. God is consciousness. We never heard Sanatana Dharma. We didn't have education. All our education is through schools. Okay? And all our learning is through some form of TV, serials, and. Very faithfully following. The real Sanatana Dharma, what is teaching is the consciousness is God.
Babaji, na?
Alle, just a second.
Can you mute? You can admit.
Yeah, yeah.
Where is it? Where is
it? Ha.
You can ask him.
Uma, HK Uma, can you please mute your noise is coming from your side.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Thank you. Okay, thank you. So, what? It's okay. So, that is printed. Okay, so the consciousness in Sanatana Dharma we call consciousness alone is God. Pradnanam Brahma. Never heard of it. And that is told as your Atma. Never heard of it. Okay, and that is the most neglected part of our life. This class focuses only on the consciousness or being part. Try to help you to understand how you are mixed up consciousness with the body mind. Become clarity that you are consciousness. To bring that clarity, the class is all. That's all. Right? Now, what will happen if you neglect the most important aspect of you, which is actually you are not a human, you are a being. If you neglect yourself, what will happen to you?
Very unhappy.
Very unhappy. Right? So, we think that I am unhappy because something is happening in life. Okay? Because my friend is not well. Because I failed in exam. None of this is the reason for your unhappiness. The reason for unhappiness is you are neglected the most important part of you, being. You tell me, how much time you give to your husband or he demands from you? How much time you give to children? How much time you give to puja? The time you give to yourself is called meditation. The time you give to your real self is called nididhyasa. So if you don't give time to yourself, what will happen to your life? Thoughts, unnecessary thoughts, worries, stress builds up. Okay? It is like a plant. You water the plant. Okay?
The plant gives you beautiful flowers. You put water to flowers. Then what happened to the plant? The plant will suffer. Put water to the root. Your root of your life is being, not the body, not the mind, not the intellect. They are the instruments. Okay? How to go back to that self is the class. Any questions? You are not human at all. You are being, using human. We live with the wrong idea that I am a human being. In the best way you can say is being human, you can say. Being first and human next. That's more closer.
Then why do you need all this body and all this? You can interact.
No, see, why do you need a mobile phone? Mobile phone is an instrument.
Conscious, you are conscious.
There's no interaction. I and you are one. There's no interaction. For the interaction purpose, we need to put on a body. So you want to do some dancing?
One,
we'll find out. One consciousness, many consciousness, find out. That one consciousness operates to many bodies. That one consciousness called Paramatma, operating to individual bodies called Atma. Okay? So, purpose of interaction, purpose of creation is there. But when you forget yourself, there's a trouble. Okay? So, now let me ask you a question. When you are born to your parents, okay, how many children your mother had? When you were born to your mother, how many children were born? The question will be clear. When you were born to your mother, how many children were born? One. What about you?
Two.
You have two children, mother has two children.
Mother, three. I have two.
No. When you were born to your mother.
Two. My two.
No. Forget it. When you were born to your mother, how many children are born? See, the question is, these questions here are very tricky, okay? You have to very carefully listen. When you were born to your parents, how many children were born? Sir, Guru Prasad. No, that's others. What about you? When you were born, how many were born? One to one. Sure. When we are born, three were born. You know that? Don't know that? So, when you were born, one cell from your body, please understand, one cell from your body, okay? One cell from mother's body and one cell from father's body became two, right? What is the contribution of your father and mother?
One cell each.
One cell each. But now how many cells you have in your body? Trillions. The two cells became four. Four became eight. Eight became 16. It became meat ball. Then somewhere eyes developed, somewhere ears developed, somewhere nose developed, somewhere tongue developed in that meatball. Did your father and mother make it? Huh? No? Sure. They just contribute one cell each. After that, there's mera responsibility nahi. Right? Right? See, ear has to come, right? Eyes have to come here only. It didn't come here. Then if you ask scientists what it will say, it becomes genes. Okay, who reads the genes? Genes is a memory. It's like a SIM card. Somebody should read the genes now. And say, eyes have to come here. Who is that reading? That is the divine mother, universal mother. So the universal mother created your body out of those two cells. Into four intelligence. To make the eyes to fix here, ears to fix here, intelligence is required now. And where is the intelligence there? That is the universal intelligence. That we call as Divine Mother. Have you done puja for our mother, Divine Mother? Go to the temple and do puja. Forgetting that, your entire body is created by the Divine Mother. your parents' contribution was only 2 cells. Okay. So then, a biological child is born. So who are the parents? Your father and mother. Correct? But father and mother only contribute 2 cells now. Contributing 2 cells and claiming the whole body is, I don't know. You think it's fair? I only produce the child. I only. Okay. They just contribute 2 cells and claiming the whole thing. And lifelong also. Okay. The universal mother, that's what we call a Shakti, the divine mother. That's why we do divine mother puja in various temples. We only think of divine mother like that. We don't see what's happening here. Okay. Your biological parents just contribute 2 cells. But throughout your life, if I ask your parents who are the parents, what you'll say? Huh? You'll tell about biological parents. Just 2 cells. And your resume is there, right? What is the right resume? Son and so father. Actually, the core contribution, entire hard work is done by the divine mother. You take the cells, multiply them, create a brain, put a cell, wiring you do. The universe releases his brain. And you totally very happily forgotten. And you write biological parents only. So, okay, we'll give you recognition to them. Okay, biological parents, 2 cells. And the entire body is made by the divine mother. Huh? Have you recognized the divine mother? You have given naivedya, you have done puja. But you didn't recognize any contribution, no? But biological parents' contribution you recognize. Oh, you do the schooling, all those things, all difficulties. But divine mother does more also. She operates your eyes. You know how to make the eyes operate? Ears operate? Nose to function? Which doctor knows? They can do some surgery. The intelligence is required to make the brain operate. Intelligence is required to eyes operate. Who is doing that? Your heart has to beat regularly. Who is doing that?
Divine.
The universal intelligence. Divine intelligence is common to all. That's why my heart also beats at some rate and your heart also beats. It's universal, not for individual. So your biological parents are in somewhere now. Once in a while you go and say, our happy Mother's Day or something like that. The divine mother is running the whole show every day. If she doesn't do, you can't get up. You can't open your eyes. So, are we clear now? One is biological child is born to the great contribution of a parents, 2 cells. Okay? And divine mother has created the body. But the body doesn't work unless the consciousness comes into picture. Are you conscious? All of you? Huh? Are you sure? So, the consciousness came from where? The consciousness came from Shiva, the conscious divine father. You understand? So, you have another set of parents. Who are they? Shiva and Shakti. I am sure you are not never mentioned in that resume. You understand? Huh? The entire life you forget your divine parents and you leave biological parents or parents, really their contribution is very, very small. You understand? Are you clear? The consciousness is the father, Shakti, universal intelligence is the mother. Now the third, this is second child, consciousness. Okay? So this consciousness is called being. The body is called human. The body is created by the divine mother. The consciousness is given by Shiva. No doctor can inject one consciousness into you. Consciousness, but the body parts can be done. Human parts you can buy it. Right? Human parts, kidney, liver, you can buy it. My brother is a doctor. Okay? One of his patients was in a coma. Then some relative came and said, I want to take the patient, I don't want to leave the hospital. And he said he's a brother or something and signed document and took it. And after some days, the villagers are coming and shouting in the hospital, okay, saying that that woman's kidney hospital stolen. This guy is not a relative. He is actually some criminal. In the name of relative, he has taken that body and disposed of all whatever organs are there. The human part, you can get anything. Consciousness, you cannot get. Okay, the Shakti, intelligence, energy, you cannot get. Prana, you cannot get. So that is biological father and biological mother. So how many parents you have now? Two sets. Okay, now another important parent comes into picture. Right? The child, what is the nature of the child? Please tell me. What is the nature of the child? The child, is it peaceful? It hungry to cry. Otherwise, it is peaceful. There's a joy in the child. Right? Child is blissful. That bliss is coming from Shiva, the father. Okay. But now why your life is messful? Why it's messed out? When your nature, by genetically your father and mother give genes, so you have eyes of your father, ears of your mother, okay, nose of your grandparent, something like that, and your bliss of your Shiva is given, package deal, born. So now why your life is mess? Why you are stressed out? Please tell me. Then because of the third child. This is the third child. Now the child is blissful, very blissful, okay? It doesn't know. Then the parents are not happy with the blissful child. The child has to be like us only. Mera beta, my it has to be like one. You give a name to the child. So name is Papa Papa. Okay? The child mother comes and says, Papa, Papa. The child doesn't know. It will blink. It's blissful. Papa, Papa. Bangaru, Papa. The child doesn't know. So child keeps on blinking. One day it starts recognizing, oh, Papa means me. Then the problem starts. Now you start identifying the body. Okay, the once you identify the body, all trouble starts. Otherwise, your consciousness, Shiva. That's why we say child is divine. That's why we say child is divine. Because only divine consciousness is there. Now the society consciousness brought. Society consciousness brought in the form of mind. You point out, oh, boy should be like this, girl should be like this, okay, you should be like this. And the third child is born. It's called mind. Mind. By birth, the child has very rudimentary mind. The third child is called society child. Now, how many parents you have? A mistake. Biological parents?
No, divine parents.
Divine parents? Society has how many parents? Okay, everyone is a parent. Even a person going, movie character also is a parent. They teach you. Now, all your mess in life is because of society child. Okay, so now who do you think you are? The divine child, human child, or society child? Who do you think you are? Biological child, or divine child, or society child? You tell me who you are. Okay, what's your name? Huh? Diksha. You tell me who are you out of these three? See, what is your date of birth? 25th February. 25th February, the society child is not there. Society child is produced after that. It came later. All your stress and worry is because of this intruder who is called mind. You understand? Are you clear? Mind is required, no doubt. But mind is not you. It came to you. That you differentiate your mission. Mind is what you got from the society. Mind is not what is original for you. Original is biological child and divine child. Are we clear? So now entire life is to get out of this problem called society child. Please tell me, any of your stress, any of your struggle, is it because of society? Biological child has a problem. What is that? 1, 2, 3 is the problem. And it grows up old, some stomach ache, pain, other than no problem. What is the problem with divine child? The being, the consciousness, no problem. Society child, has it got any solution at all in life? Any solution is there? All your problems are because of the? You cannot get rid of society child, okay? You have to live in the society child. Right? I'm not saying get rid of the society child. Do you understand what I'm saying? Kid? Huh? Who are you really?
Divine child.
Ah. Why are you living your life? All life as a society child, you tell me. You live in a society, you live as a society child. But don't be, you know you are who you are. You understand? You should know who you are. You may interact in society interaction, your husband comes, what do you think? I am a divine child. Husband, you have to work as him. Your wife only. But deep inside, you should know divine child. Just like, right? When your husband comes, okay, when somebody asks, which place are you from? What do you say, madam? Huh? What do you say, which place are you from? Answer.
Yeah, where I was born.
Adu tavaru mane. Illidu nam mane. Yavadu tavaru mane alli, idu nam mane, gandana mane. Gandana mane permanent agilla adu. Gandana mane idu tavaru mane. Okay, always remember our original house. Even though when we live in the interact. Like that, our divine nature, we should be always remembering while interacting with society, then you'll be very peaceful. Is this much clear to all? Any questions? Guru Prasad Ore? Am I making sense? So, we are a hybrid. Three child. One is divine child. Okay? One is human child. And other is society. Society. Thousands and thousands of parents. And they pull you in multiple directions. Any decision you make in your life is because of society. Okay. Now, what happened to the divine child? What happened to the divine child? Forgot. But anything happened, any problem is there for the divine child? There will be no problem for the divine child. But the noise of the society child is occupying all our mind. Give some few minutes of a day to go to the divine child. You know, that's called meditation. Are you doing that? No, I'm spending time in puja. Puja is because of the society told you, do this puja. Did society tell you, go back to yourself? That's only thing which our Vedas and Upanishads and Rishis are telling you. Are you clear? Understand? Now, I'll just tell you the problem. When you are in the mother's womb, was it a comfortable situation? Food is taken care. Okay. Nothing to ask for, no crying. Everything is taken care. Okay. Born, you are blissful. Now you are in a mess. Otherwise, you don't have come to this class now. Right? What happened? This is the society child. Eating your head full day in various ways. Society child should be there, but we should treat the society child as not me and handle it. But we are getting messed up with it. We means who? We are who? The being, the consciousness. Are you clear now? Now, how many of you people order something from Amazon? Have you ordered something from Amazon?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, you get something from Amazon and it's not in a good condition. You return it. They will take it back?
Yeah.
Huh? They'll take it. Return policy is there, right?
Mm-hmm.
But
before 30 days.
Before. So good. So that Amazon, when it comes in a nice packaging, bubble sheet and everything, right? Now you use it after 1 month is over, 2 months are over, then you damage it. Then did they take it back?
No.
They won't take it back, right? Same thing happens here also. So when the Divine Father and Divine Mother, Shiva and Shakti, manufacture and package and send, they send it a very nice packaging. Bubble sheet. No damage can happen in 9 months transit, right? Other mobile phone and other Amazon comes two days delivery. It takes only 9 months to delivery, and it's very nicely packaged, put and done. Everything is taken care of, right? No damage will happen. And when the child is born, does the manufacturer gives the warranty is given? What manufacturer gives the warranty? Mobile phone. This will work, right? And the child is born, manufacturer warranty is satisfied or not? What is the manufacturer warranty? Shiva says, I'll send my copy, the consciousness. And nature of consciousness is blissful. So the manufacturer has satisfied the delivery in a blissful condition. Every child is blissful. Even if their eyes is not, their ears are not, the child is blissful. Understand? So deliveries also. I mean, some child is born without eyes, ears, or because of whatever reason, but the child is blissful. Only when other people say, you don't have eyes, the child starts feeling mess. Are you clear? So God has kept his promise. Shiva and Shakti. Now, usage starts. Primary usage is the parents, secondary is the grandparents, third is the society. And the product gets damaged like this. Okay. Now, if you return to the manufacturer, what will the manufacturer say? What will the manufacturer say?
Time is up, you can't
give. I didn't set this condition. Original condition is damaged, it's not acceptable. Go back. Again, come back. So that's called Punarapi Jananam. Punarapi Maranam. Punarapi Janani. Jatare Shayanam. Iya Samsare. Bahudussare. Krapaya Pare. Pahi Murare. This is what our ancestors called cycle of birth and rebirth. In the usage, it gets damaged. So in the usage, if you get it repaired and go back in original condition, accept it. You don't have to come back. That's called mukti. Understand? So what do you have to do for that? This damages condition. You have to go to service center. You go to service center. The service center is called Guru. He will try to do whatever patch up is possible and try to bring back to original condition. Sometimes it doesn't work. Sometimes it works. And if you go to wrong service center, then another Murphasa damage. Understand? This is spirituality, is this much only. Are you clear? As your mind becomes so peaceful, you start living your life as a divine child. That's called Jivanmukti. If you do that, then there's no rebirth. If you don't do that, until you learn to do that in many lifetimes, you keep on coming. Is karma theory understood? So, the teaching here is called Tattvamasi. You are that. This is the only, if you have the entire Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad has to be summarized. So big Veda, so big Upanishad, so many puja, so many yadnas, ultimately it has to be summarized in 3 lines. Tattvamasi. So you recognize your true self, true being, not the body, not the mind, not the intellect, as consciousness. And consciousness is divine. You start recognizing that and start living that in your life, you become peaceful. This is the only teaching of Adhyatma. Okay? So this I'd say, Nanu.
Nanembudu.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Ideha.
Mana
Buddhi,
Nanalla,
Sachidanandatma, Shivananunani, Shivoham, Shivoham,
Shivoham.
I am not the body. I am not the mind.
I am
not the intellect.
I
have a body.
I have
a mind.
I have
an intellect.
I
am pure consciousness.
I am pure consciousness.
Shiva Swarupi. Shiva is not a person. Shiva is the consciousness. Okay. So we are accustomed to seeing Shiva as a person. Shiva is your consciousness. Who is blissful? Who is Ananda? So recognize our Shiva nature is called Atmadarshana class. Right? So now we give a rest of 10 minutes. Those people who are on the online also, you can go for a restroom. After 10 minutes, we'll start the class again. Sorry, you can take a break. So you can take a break. So after 10 minutes, you restart the class. You can have a cup of coffee or tea and start the class again. How do you go to sharing mode here?
Yeah. Share screen.
Huh. Okay. Shall we start? I don't know whether there are people in the remote. They'll join, of course. Oh, I think so. Let us chant Omkar 3 times. You have heard this sloka, right? Tvameva mata, pita tvameva, tvameva bandho, sakha tvameva, tvameva vidya, dravinam tvameva, tvameva deva, mama deva deva.
Mama Deva Deva.
Now, you were telling mechanically earlier. Now, does it make sense? What does it really mean? Tomeo Mata means what?
You are the father or the mother.
You means consciousness. You means consciousness is here. So every day in biodata we keep writing biological father and mother. They are just little bit small contribution, that's all. And you are saying, this is my son. What is my son, my daughter? No, my son, my daughter. All are divine sons and daughters. Everything belongs to God. The consciousness. Tvameva mata, pita tvameva. Consciousness is the father. Shakti is the mother. They are the real father and real mother. Your biological parents are conduit two cells. Tvameva pita, tvameva mata. Tvameva bandhu, sakha tvameva. How is friend? The friend we call as body. Body is not friend, it's an instrument. The being, human part we are calling as a friend. Human part is not friend. The being part is a friend. Will you talk? Will you go for a picnic with your somebody who is not alive? That aliveness is called being. That is the real friend. And that is called Atma. That is called Param. That's one part of Param. That's a part of Paramatma. He is the God, he is the friend. Tomeva bandhu, sakha tomeva. Bandhu means relative. Sakha means relative. Tomeva vidya dravindam, the one who gave knowledge, guru. You are the one.
Now, what are we living? We are living illusion that I am the body and the friend is the body, father is the body, mother is the body, forgetting the real consciousness which is making it alive. The consciousness is like electricity. Okay. If the electricity is not there, no bulb will be on. The bulb is the human part. Electricity is the being part. Okay. Now only bulb we are thinking as human. The real being is the consciousness. So once we start understanding this, we start living in the reality. Otherwise, we are living in the illusion. That's called Maya. We are living in the illusion that body is the person. Body is not the person. The being is the person. Being you cannot see. Body you can see. Bulb you can see. Light you can see. But electricity you cannot see. Okay. That electricity, that consciousness is myself. And once I start recognizing conscious myself, I recognize conscious you, everybody. Okay. So now the session starts. First, let us do namaskara. You have done your namaskara in life, no? So mechanically, you do it. What is namaskara means?
To pray.
Namaskara means the God in me and the God in you are one. We are one. Understand? Namaskara is not in the body. Body is a machine. Okay, all our life we think that we are doing namaskara to the body. We are an illusion. We are not doing namaskara to the body. We are doing namaskara to the Chaitanyam, consciousness in you and consciousness in me is one. There are no two consciousness. And that one consciousness is called God. Okay, and how do you do that? There's too much has gone here. What is this too much gone here? Please tell me. Society child is sitting here. Too much of society child. Drop their society child. Then recognize consciousness me and consciousness you. So on. That's called namaskar. Namaskar. Nama. I am not the body. I am not the mind. I am not the intellect. Nama means I am not. Then what I am? Consciousness. Chaitanyam. The Chaitanya in me and Chaitanya in you is one. That is namaskar. So, try start doing consciously. When you do mechanically, don't do mechanically. Even do namaskar to God, temple also. Understand. God is nothing but consciousness. I am one with that consciousness. Again and again to remember that our ancestors have made this very simple practices. You understood?
Yeah.
Now get up and explain to people. Explain to people what you understood.
It means that in this hand, the God is there. In this hand, our God is there. Both are seamless.
It's not, God is not in hand. God is in whole of the body. So I'm saying God in me and God in you are one. Understand? So we are doing namaskara not to human being. We are human. We are doing namaskara to being, which is God. Everywhere. You understand? So we need to clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So is this class okay for you?
Yeah.
You're still kids. It's okay? Okay. Now we'll do namaskara. Just let me. Okay. So now we'll do, I'll chant a mantra. We'll give namaskara or respect to the God in us. Antarjyotihi.
Antarjyotihi.
Bahirjyotihi.
Bahirjyotihi.
Pratyakjyotihi.
Pratyakjyotihi.
Paratpara.
Paratpara.
Swayam jyotihi.
Swayam jyotihi.
Jyotireva jyotihi.
Jyotireva Jyotihi.
Shivosmiham.
Shivosmiham.
Jyotireva Jyotihi.
Jyotireva Jyotihi.
Atma Jyoti.
Atma Jyoti.
Shivosmiham.
Shivosmiham.
Let me repeat again. Antar Jyotihi.
Antar Jyotihi.
Bahir Jyotihi.
Bahir Jyotihi.
Pratyak Jyotihi.
Pratyak Jyotihi.
Paratpara.
Paratpara.
Swayam Jyotihi.
Swayam Jyotihi.
Jyotireva Jyotihi.
Jyotireva Jyotihi.
Atma Jyotihi.
Atma Jyotihi.
Shivosmyaham.
Shivosmyaham.
What is this? This is the title song. In James Bond movie, they go like that. This is the title song of Atma Jyoti Satsang. Anthem. Okay, Atma Jyoti. This satsang is called Atma Jyoti. Okay, the Atma Jyoti is the divine light in me. Okay. That's the highest realization. The divine light in me is called highest realization. This is actually written by Shankaracharya. This is the highest realization anybody can have. I am that light, the divine light. In Islam, that light is called Nur. It's there in all these religions. Okay? In Islam, it's called Nur, the divine light. In Sanatana Dharma, it's called Atma Jyoti, the light of the self. Okay? So the light of self cannot be seen. You cannot see it. Then you say, one day I did a meditation and I saw a beautiful light. I saw Atma Jyoti. No. One who sees it is Atma Jyoti. The seer is the Jyoti, not the seen. Okay? So, you will never be able to see Atma Jyoti because you are the Atma Jyoti. But gradually when you start recognizing the Atma Jyoti in you, you start recognizing Atma Jyoti everywhere. The divine light. That brings immense peace and love in you. Seeing Atma Jyoti in you is called peace. Seeing Atma Jyoti everywhere is called love. The peace is called mukti. Love is called bhakti. Okay. Now you have a concept of love. The concept of love is based on the body, shape, and the real love is universal love. When you start seeing the divine light everywhere, you start experiencing the divine light. That's called Atma Jyoti. Is that? Shankaracharya's teaching. So this I have said, based on that, this satsang name is called Atma Jyoti Satsang. So I call everybody as Atma Jyoti. So everybody initials are Gayatri, AJ Gayatri. Now what is this AJ Gayatri? Initials Gayatri. Okay, it's all called, I call Atma Jyoti. It's a spiritual name. To remember that we are the divine selves. That's all. Because our name is our binding. Name starts the ego. I told you, the moment you give a name, the child's ego starts. The divine child starts mixing up with the society child. So, the spiritual name for all of us, it's not I given by me, it's the divine name, is Atma Jyoti. So, that's why I call people as Atma Jyoti. Okay, this is Atma Jyoti. Antar Jyoti, the inner light, is called the divine name, awareness. Okay, awareness is light, not physical light. Bahir Jyoti, outer light. Pratyak Jyoti, the innermost light. I'll explain as we go conduct classes. I'll tell you what are these meaning means. Really, you start understanding it. Swayam Jyoti, that's a self-effulgent light. It doesn't, every light, it requires something lighting up. It doesn't require lighting up. Jyoti Reva Deyoti, I am the light. Everywhere this light. Shivosmiham, I am that light called Shiva. So that's where you start recognizing your nature as divine. So that's the Atma Jyoti. That is respecting our inner light. So then respecting the masters, it's traditional to give the respect to our masters. So here is Ajja, who taught me all this teaching of self-inquiry. His name is Ajja. He lived in Puttur. Then the teaching is based on non-duality teachings by Shankaracharya and Gaudapadacharya. The non-duality teaching was made very simple and communicated to people by Sri Ramana Maharshi and one person called Atmananda Krishna Menon. He lived in Kerala at the same time as Ramana Maharshi. Okay, he is not as famous as Ramana Maharshi, but what he did is Ramana Maharshi's teaching is his own teaching, Atma Lakshman. It's a tradition, ancient teaching. He developed a system of teaching. And that teaching, Amritandamai, lives. See, recognizing inner self is recognizing divinity everywhere. And that is a universal love. Okay? She has inspired millions and millions of people worldwide by pure love. So the spirituality is just experience that divine love. Divine peace is called mukti. Divine love is called bhakti. So the experience of this is called Atmadnana. So what are the steps involved in Atmadnana? I'm just trying to finish it. So let us give our respect to Guru, Guru Parampara. Now here you may have some other Guru, you may have some other Guru. Doesn't matter, all Gurus are one in the consciousness. But if you think that you have to give respect to some Guru, any Guru, you give a Guru. It doesn't matter which Guru, it's ultimately everything is consciousness. Brahmanandam,
Brahmanandam,
Paramasukadam,
Paramasukadam,
Kevalam,
Kevalam,
Nanamurtim,
Nanamurtim,
Dvandvatitam,
Dvandvatitam,
Gaganasadrisham,
Gaganasadrisham,
Tattvamasyadilaksham,
Tattvamasyadilaksham,
Ekam Nityam,
Ekam Nityam,
Vimalamachalam,
Vimalamachalam,
Sarvadi Sakshibhutam, Bhavatitam,
Bhavatitam,
Tripunarahitam,
Tripunarahitam,
Sadgurum,
Sadgurum,
Tam Namami,
Tam Namami.
See, the respect is given to Sadguru, is a realized master. Okay. Somebody who has realized inspires us realization. And Sadguru is your inner self also, Atma Guru. But what happens? We don't know our Atma Guru. Sadguru shows our Atma Guru. Okay. External teacher is called Sadguru, inner teacher is called Atma Guru. Purpose of Sadguru is to awaken your inner Guru. Okay. He is the supreme happiness. Actually, ultimate happiness is called Brahmananda. The self-realization is Brahmanandam. And he is pure knowledge, absolute knowledge. And he is Dvandvatitam. Actually, what we are getting troubled in the world is happiness, unhappiness, good and bad. This is called Dvandva. So we have to go beyond Dvandva. And he is like a space. He is all pervading. He is not a person, a body. Even though he operates through a body, but consciousness is all pervading. Tattvamasi, his only teaching. Please understand, there are a lot of people that teaching Guru this, be happy, be merry, do this. They're all what he called behavioral teaching. There's a lot of this required also. So many classes go on behavioral teaching and yoga and all. The final teaching is Tattvamasi, that the word. That's called Atma Darshan. There's only final class. Everything else is lower level. So it's like a school, primary school, middle school, high school, college is there. Final teaching is Tattvamasi. That's called Atma Darshana. Okay. Who is one eternal? He is changeless. He has no birth, no death. His body may die, but he is deathless. He is a Sakshi. He is the one who is witnessing what's happening in our mind. Who is beyond modifications and who is beyond three modes of nature, Sattva Guna, Rajo Guna, Tamo. What is this? We'll understand. Guru Brahma,
Guru Brahma,
Guru Vishnu,
Guru Vishnu,
Guru Devo,
Guru Devo,
Maheshwaraha,
Maheshwaraha,
Guru Sakshat,
Guru Sakshat,
Parabrahma,
Parabrahma,
Tasmai Shri,
Tasmai Shri,
Gurave Namaha,
Gurave Namaha.
See, this Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, we call as devatas for creation. In reality, our awareness, consciousness is Brahma. Okay? When you wake up, the world is projected. When you go to sleep, the world is withdrawn at the micro level. At the macro level, there's a creation. But individual level also, we experience that creation and dissolution. So that is consciousness. Okay. Now, the consciousness of Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara is there in the form of consciousness in us. Of course, universal level, it happens in a big scale. At individual level, it happens in daily scale. And one who awakens us to that consciousness, Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara in you, is Sadguru.
Chaitanyam.
Chaitanyam.
Shashvatam Shantam.
Shashvatam Shantam.
Yomatitam.
Yomatitam.
Niranjanam.
Niranjanam.
Nadu Bindu.
Nadu Bindu.
Kalatitam.
Kalatitam.
Tasmai Shri.
Tasmai Shri.
Gurave Namaha.
Gurave Namaha.
Chaitanyam. Chaitanya. Awareness. See, our body dies. Our mind dies. But awareness doesn't die. That's called Atma. Okay? That Atma we have to recognize when you are alive. Otherwise, we'll have to keep taking birth after birth to recognize that. That awareness, and it's peace, absolute peace. Only when you reach Atma, you'll get peace. Otherwise, whatever effort you do for peace is temporary. No amount of effort will make you peaceful. Okay? I respect my Sadhguru and my inner Guru. Who is Chaitanyam, Atma? Adnana.
Adnana.
Timirandasya.
Timirandasya.
Jnananjana.
Jnananjana.
Shalakaya.
Shalakaya.
Chakshur.
Chakshur.
Unmilitam yena.
Unmilitam yena.
Tasmai Shri.
Tasmai Shri.
Gurave Namaha.
Gurave Namaha.
So I am living in ignorance. I am thinking that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. I am living as human. Okay. Sadhguru shows me the way to recognize I am divine. I am pure consciousness. I am the being. I am the divine child. One who shows that through surgical instrument. My eyes is like Adnana Thirunalaji. I have a cancer, the cataract, blind. So that has to be done surgery. What is the method of doing surgery? Is through Atmajnana, the self-knowledge. I respect Sadhguru, whose eyes are half closed. So we see that yogis are half closed. They are symbolic aperture. I mean, it doesn't mean half closed is good. Half closed means even when he sees the world, he is aware to the inner world. Simultaneously, he is aware of a, see what happens is for us when we interact with the world, we forget the inner self. Okay, Atma is forgotten. And we may meditate, probably we recognize Atma, but when you come to the outside, we forget. So, one who has realized being, he is, even when he is interacting with society, in waking state or dream state, he is aware of his inner self. That's half closed eyes. In a sculpture, it represents half closed eyes. In reality, what it means is that his awareness, his self-awareness is never lost. Akhanda mandalakaram.
Akhanda mandalakaram.
Vyaptam yena characharam.
Vyaptam yena characharam.
Tatpadam darshitam yena.
Tatpadam darshitam yena.
Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha.
Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha.
Akhanda mandalakaram means everything in the universe is pervaded by Guru Tattva. See, space is everywhere. Right? Is space everywhere? Is there anything which is outside the space? Right? But where is the space? The space is in my mind. If I don't have mind, space is not there. The infinite space is called Bhutakasha, physical space. That infinite space of Bhutakasha is in my mental space. My mind recognizes it. That means my mental space is bigger than the Bhutakasha. That mental space is called Chittakasha. But mind is appearing and disappearing in consciousness. Chidakasha. Chidakasha is called Atma. And Atma is called Guru. So all pervading Akhanda Mandalakaram Vyaptam in Charachara. So this teaching is based on direct path called self-inquiry. What is direct path? I'll tell you later. So what is the purpose of this whole thing? Om.
Om.
Namadaha.
Purnamidam.
Purnamidam. Purnasya.
Purnasya.
Purnat.
Purnat.
Purnamudashyate.
Purnamudashyate.
Purnasya.
Purnasya.
Purnamadaya.
Purnamadaya.
Purnamevavashishyate.
Purnamevavashishyate.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Purna means that is Purna, which is called self.
which is called Bhagavan, God. He is complete, he is infinite. He has created this infinite universe, Purna. And this Purna, infinite universe merges back into Bhagavan, but doesn't make any difference to this. And that Bhagavan is myself, Atma. Until I recognize that I am Apurna, I am incomplete. So to recognize, this is the teaching of Upanishad, that recognize that inner self in you, then only you'll become Purna. Now, what are things you do to become Purna? Tell me.
Eat good food.
I'm married because I'm my better half. I am half actually. And after marriage, another quarter came. Two quarters came also. So to become full, we need to do a lot of effort. I mean, somebody eat a lot of things and become full also. And then they eat, stop eating and reduce become. To become full, we try to do so many things. Okay. Every effort to become full is failure. Right? And most of us, you know, all are you married. Okay? So only way to become Purna is through Atmajnana, self-knowledge. Such a guru with respect. Okay. So now we'll go to today's class. Actually, we are starting. This is preliminary because I today being the first class, I had to give some more detail. So now we'll take the class. So I'll be teaching meditations in various ways. Okay, many times it will be more of a discussion. It's called prakriyas. There are various prakriyas, and these prakriyas are not made by Prabhu. Okay, these prakriyas are made by rishis. Only thing is my contribution is to understand them and make it applicable to modern society. Convert them in a language which you can understand, from the complex technical jargon to simple understanding. That's my contribution of this person. But it's not my making. Whatever they have made, it's written in very complex texts which are hidden. I'm trying to bring it in a way which you can understand. If at all there's a contribution, there's a contribution. So first let us, so today's topic is called Holy Name. Okay. The Pavitra Nama, right? Why it's called Holy Name? Why called holy name? Why something is called holy name? Not just a name.
Associated with God.
Associated with something higher. Yeah. Okay. So the chanting of God's name purifies us. Because name is one which has spoiled us. Right? Okay. The name is the seed of the ego. Name is where our ego started. And ego is the one which separated us from God. Self-individuality. A child is egoless and nameless. The naming started. What's the name, sir?
Saravana.
See, how deep is the name? Just now I told Atma Jyoti, the spiritual name. So, the whole spiritual purpose of spiritual name is to make you again and again remember your true spirit. So you have seen this Swamiji's and all, right? They change the name. Some Ananda and all. The purpose is constantly remember their self nature. Because your name is processed to you. Okay? So the biological name is given by the parent that will remember your body. The spiritual name is given by Guru to recognize your spirit, constantly remember that. It's a practice itself. So I call people as Atma Jyoti, but I'm just giving name for sake of name. It's for you to recognize your Atma Jyoti. Constantly you keep thinking of that, then you start recognizing the inner light. The name is a holy name called because our name, the name is what we start associating the ego. Okay. So everything is a name for us, right? The moment you think of a friend, the friend's name comes in picture and the form. Which comes first, form or name? Name is deeper than the form. You are a donkey. I say, immediately the name donkey triggers something in you and form of donkey comes next. Name comes first, form comes. So, chanting of God's name and meditation on God's name is a spiritual practice. I'll teach different spiritual practices. Today is that practice. Okay. Now, chanting of God's name, don't start thinking of the God's form. Let God's form manifest based on the mantra. Mantra is the power. The sound is the root. Then form comes the next. Okay. So, what is the purpose of chanting of name? The chanting of name our ancestors made as a spiritual practice. Right? So, there's a way when people meet in UP, they say Ram Ram. Ram Ram. Okay. Ram Ram. The idea is God in me, God in you is one, and that's Ram. So that has become casual now. Okay, reality is to come out of this mess what we are in, that again and again remember God's name. Okay. So that's a practice by itself. Namaskara and God's name. I don't say that you start doing it tomorrow. Okay, I'm saying. Telling some practice, something you can do, something you may not be able to do. But I'm telling, I'm giving all fundamentals so that you can build on that. So they say Ram Ram. Then when the dead body is taken, okay, what they say?
Ram Nam
Satya. Ram Nam Satya. So Ram is not the name of the body. Ram is the name of the being or consciousness. That is Satya. That you recognize when he's alive also. They do. Recognize the Ram in the alive and Ram when he's passed away. You understand? So our society, entire society of Sanatana Dharma, Hindu society, Indian culture, lived in God consciousness. And what has happened to us? We have come to the body consciousness. Okay? Without understanding deeper spiritual roots. Have you seen any of you seen this movie called 2012? That whole thing collapses.
Only little I have seen.
Only little you have seen. So in that movie, there is a Western scientist and there's a Buddhist monk. Right? So how these two people react in the natural calamity? Have you seen? That Western scientist goes mad actually. Okay, he commits suicide. He also knows that the calamity is coming. A Buddhist monk is sitting calmly and meditating. Shishya comes and says, the world is ending. Tomorrow it will end. Let us run away. You want to run away? Run. This guy is silent and peaceful. No disturbance at all because he has found the inner truth. And the Western scientist is living in the body consciousness. Okay. So Indian society was living in God consciousness. That's why India was called Bharata. You know what is Bharata? Bha means wisdom. Rata means Ananda. The country which was blissful because of Atma Dnana was called Bharata. And our country was called Hindustan, you know? Hindu. You know why? We are called Hindu. You know why? Hindu comes from the word called Sindhu. Okay? Sindhu means ocean. Okay? We are Bindu, dots. The country of the people who have become Bindu to Sindhu is called Hindustan. It means Atma Dnana was such a knowledge, prevalent knowledge in this country. And they, in the language of Persians, it became, they could not pronounce Hindu, they pronounced Sindhu. Bindu is individual, Sindhu is the ocean, Bhagawan. One who recognizes that Bindu and Sindhu, the top merges the ocean when he is alive and he is joyful, he is called Bharata. And one who is doing that is called Hindu. And we are not taught about our real culture also. Okay, so the root of this name is the trouble. Okay, So we have to start recognizing the God's name in everything. That's why we chant the God's name. Don't we have to think of one form. God is all forms. God is everywhere. So just chant God's name. That sound vibration itself creates the beauty. Now you may have your own favorite gods, okay, that you chant. But in this group, we will chant only two mantras. Om Namah Shivaya and Krishna's mantra. And Narayana mantra. The reason is simple. The Narayana or Krishna, Krishna consciousness is Maya, is protector. Shiva consciousness is inwards, meditator. Shiva takes you inwards, Krishna takes care of protection, Vishnu. And Narayana is liberation, mukti. So these three mantras we chant here. But otherwise, whatever mantra which you like, you chant. But we'll do chanting. Okay. Now the chanting has to be done in a certain way. This body is an instrument. Right? The body is an instrument. The instrument has different centers, like a mobile phone. The center for energy, Shakti, is called here. Center for energy is the manipura. Because the food eaten, everything is digested. The center for emotion is here. The center for intellect, thoughts, is here. Center for oneness is here. These are the four buttons in our body. The four centers. We have to energize and activate those centers. Have you, any of you, when you rent a vehicle, you get a user manual? Your washing machine gets a user manual? Without user manual, can you operate that? Is this very complex, more complex than that?
Yes.
Machine? Huh? Billion times more complex. Did you get a user manual? You press some button, something will happen. Wrong button, something will happen. Right? So there's a user manual for this also. Have you heard of it? No. Madam, told you? That's called Bhagavad Gita. If you don't know how to operate rails, then you'll be in trouble. Okay? So then your operating procedure, I'm telling you now. I'm not telling you the user manual details. User manual details you can learn from Bhagavad Gita, Vijay is teaching. How to operate that, I'm telling you. Okay. These centers have been activated. Okay. That is activation from Omkar. Okay. So I'll teach you how to chant Omkar. Omkar. And that center starts getting activated. This is called energization or Diksha, whatever you call it. Okay. So Omkar has Akara, Ukara, Makara, and sound, silence. Okay. A, U, Ma, Nishabda, silence. Next 9 classes I'm doing, I'm telling little more details of Omkara. Okay, I cannot tell Omkara about Omkara one side, this thing. Little I'll tell. Because if you understand Omkara, you understand a lot of things in our Sanatana Sanskrit. The Omkara represents three centers: energy, emotion, intellect, and sakshi, the silence, God. So the creation has two aspects. One is manifest aspect and other is unmanifested. The being is manifest or unmanifest?
Unmanifested.
Being is invisible. Atma is invisible. You cannot see yourself anytime.
But in the mirror, you can see.
That's what? The body. Right? You are not the body. You are using the body. One who is using the body is invisible. See, hey, mobile phone, I'm getting a call. I can hear the call. Sound? But can I see the one who is talking? He is not visible. Like that, one who is talking through this is you, really, which is invisible. What is visible is body. It's an instrument. So the invisible part or silent part is represented by silence after omkara. Okay. The visible part has three aspects: akara, ukara, makara. They represent waking state, dream state, deep sleep state. What is that? I'll take up in separate classes. Okay. Let us chant omkara. First, chant akara. When you chant akara, your attention should go to the nabi. You see the energy. Okay. Energy channel radiating from that energy. From the nabi, the energy starts going through all through the body. So become aware of the energy movement starting from the center. Okay. Close your eyes. Chant akara. Just sit silently and observe the energy movement is happening because of this akara. Throughout the body, energy radiates in the center of nadi. Again, let's start. Silently observe the energy movement. This energy is called Shakti, Jagan Mata. Now let us move to the heart center. The chest cavity is there here. This chest cavity is the emotional center. The emotion center gets purified and devotion will come. And you chant ukar. The emotion, the devotion, the bhakti, love for God gets corrupted and becomes emotion, anger, fear and all. The emotion center gets corrupted, clear when you chant ukar. Become aware of the center, chant ukar.
Thank you.
Now we'll come to this center called Adna. This is actually at the forehead. This is where we put kumkum and prasadam and all. It is called Makara. Akara represents Brahma. Ukara represents Vishnu. Vishnu is Maya, love. Makara represents Jnana or freedom, Mukti, Shiva. Okay. When we chant Makara, start observing the vibration. It should go into the brain. It spreads throughout the body. Makara. Become aware of the energy inside the body. I am the one who is aware of the energy movement. One who is aware of the energy movement is Sakshi. I am the witness of the energy movement in the body. Energy is the Shakti. Sakshi is Shiva. Now you go to this center, it's called Makara, Omkara. The Omkara is the place when the child, when you are born as a child, it is soft. Okay, so you are feeling more connected with the total consciousness. Now with Omkara chanting through the ear, you start feeling more connected to the universe. So when you chant Omkara, attention should be here. Silently aware of the vibrations at the head.
Asatoma
Asatoma
Sadgamaya
Sadgamaya
Tamasoma
Tamasoma
Jyotirgamaya
Jyotirgamaya
Mrityorma
Mrityorma
Amritam Gamaya
Amritam Gamaya
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti
Lokaha Samastaha
Lokaha Samastaha
Sukhino Bhavantu
Sukhino Bhavantu
Lokaha Samastaha
Lokaha Samastaha
Sukhino Bhavantu
Sukhino Bhavantu
Hari Om
Hari Om
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha
Hari Om
Hari Om
For your eyes. This is called Omkara Dhyana. Okay, Omkara Dhyana has many, many deeper understandings. I'll cover it. I mean, a lot of things are available. I'll try to post them. Okay, so deeper and deeper level understanding is there that we'll take up. Now, when I say focus on vibration, are you able to see the vibration? There's a movement in the body, small, small movements. As you become, as your mind becomes sharper, you'll start to be able to start seeing much, much deeper movements. That deeper movement is called Shakti, Jagan Mata. Throughout the universe, she's controlling everything. One who is seeing is called Sakshi, which is me. Now, where should you have your attention? First, you observe Shakti. Then when I say sit silently, the observing that energy movement is called Dhyana. Okay. Just be yourself means stay as the observer, not observed. Become aware that I am the observer of the energy movement. Can you see the observer? You'll never be able to see the observer. You just remember that I am the observer. For example, you see the face in the mirror. Okay. So I can see that this is not me. I am here, one who is seeing it. You have to remember that I am the seer. That's all. You cannot see your face. Like that, Sakshi is the seer. Observed is the Shakti. Word. So the attention in Nididhyasa has to go to the seer. Attention in meditation has to go to the seen. Dhyana is about seeing. Nididhyasa is about the seer, Atma. Okay. You don't have to change your attention. You just become aware that I am seeing. Become aware. So then become self-awareness starts growing. That one who is aware is not limited by the body and mind. He is infinite. You'll never be able to experience infinity because infinity cannot experience itself. You'll never be able to see your face, but you have to, you'll be able to recognize the face in the reflection. Like that, any changes in the world, you should be able to recognize the self. Who is the observer, witness? How big is the witness? How far is the witness? You will never be able to find out because the witness cannot see itself. Witness is infinite. Infinite cannot see itself. Atma is infinite. Cannot see itself. You can only recognize Atma in the presence of a reflection, mirror. Energy is the Shakti, mirror. Shakti is there for Shiva to recognize himself. Is this clear? So you have to remember, I am the witness, stay. You don't have to do anything. Just become aware that you are aware. Okay. So shall we do it again? Is this clear? Any questions are there? Your question. Anybody has a question? Anybody has a doubt? So this is called Pranava Dhyana or Omkara Dhyana. This is a part of Omkara Upasana. Okay, Omkara Upasana is several stages are there. So I'll teach you simple in simple way. This is called Omkara Dhyana. Okay. So in Omkara Dhyana, you do each Bija Mantra, you chant and observe the vibration, sit silently. So the more you observe that, the mind becomes silent. Then finally, when you come to Omkara, observe the vibration, then sit silently. When I say sit silently, you just be aware of the vibration and
be aware of a subtle sound. There is a subtle sound called ki-ki-ki-ki-ki-ki happens. I don't know. In like forest sound. Have you heard of the forest sound?
Mm-hmm.
The forest sound is the original Omkara sound. Okay. Listen to that. Now, be aware that one who is listening is I. That's all. Listen. Like when you are seeing the reflection in the mirror, this is the reflection. I am the seer. Just remember. You don't have to run away from the reflection. Right? So why that happens is, why that? Because the mind will start getting into drifted into thoughts. Okay. So you remember your true nature. I am the seer. And then my thoughts come. Just mentally chant Om and remember your true nature. Take your attention to yourself, which is observer. Right? In that way, thoughts will start raising drastically. Shall we start again? So we will be it's a 1:10 now. We'll be closing at 2:00, including lunch. After lunch, is it anybody getting late? Is that anybody in a hurry? 2:00, we are out after lunch. It's okay. So now this holy name Omkara purifies four centers of our body. Manipura chakra, which is the energy center. Okay. If the energy center gets purified, health improves. It's the nadi. It improves the emotion center. Emotions get purified. All our emotions are stuck here, right? When your friend goes out, what happens? Emptiness here. When you have anger, burning. Alright? Emotion center. Now emotion center, why emotion center? There's no devotion. No, I do puja. Puja is external. God is inside. Okay. So the devotional center starts opening up, flowering. That's why it's holy. Then intellect. What happens in the intellect? Our mind is bombarded with a lot of thoughts. Confusion. Should do this? Should not do this. So gradually all this confusion will go and the intellect becomes clearer, more and more clearer. Simple. And then Adna, his center, when it gets vibrations, the heart feeling connected to the inner oneness. Okay. That's why its whole name is purifying. Okay. We kept kumkum here, right? Why? Fashion show?
Respect for God.
Adna Chakra. This Adna Chakra has to be activated. Okay. Adna Chakra is God inside. So he will activate now in intellect, buddhi. It's a button there. Like a machine has a button, mobile phone has a button. These are the buttons. 1, 2, 3, 4. Purifying buttons. Okay. So I will chant. Right? It starts. Let us chant Akara. Let the vibration propagate to whole part of the body, all part of the body, head, leg, everywhere, from that center. In terms of emotions get corrected, intellectual benefit because the brain and nervous system becomes purified and the clarity will emerge in the thought process. And final Omkara will help you to merge with the infinite consciousness. If you are able to get Atmadnana or Jivan Mukti when you are arrived through Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa and Atma Vichara, that means you have really Atma Darshana, then you are Jivan Mukta. Okay, then there's no question of birth and death is irrelevant. But some people, unfortunately, they will not be able to get Jivan Mukti and they are alive. For them, just practice of Omkara itself gives an opportunity for liberation at the time of death. That's what Shri Krishna says. Okay, this sloka is called, this is actually from chapter 8, shloka 13. Just omkara chanting itself has a highest benefit in terms of health, physical, mental, and spiritual. So today I have told you the omkara dhyana, the benefit of omkara dhyana. Next class we'll take some more detailed understanding of omkara dhyana, and we will get into different type of practices. See, I will be giving you different types of practices. Now it's for you to experiment and find out which will suit you, which you like, which you can do more comfortably, you do it. But I will give you a variety of practices and variety of teachings. Okay, because this class is nine months. I want you to transfer as much as wisdom as possible. I mean, I could do only Omkar Dhyana for 10 classes. That's not possible. But I have already given a lot of talks and a lot of information is available in Omkara. So that you can find through app. Okay. And what you can do is 8.13. It's serious. Okay. So Omkara Dhyana, I have told. Similarly, I'll tell you various different types of practices which are told as great practices by Rishis. So finally, you adapt one or two practices which are beneficial to you. Okay. Any questions? Okay. So this is called holy name. Name is holy because it purifies you when you are alive, and it helps you to get liberation when you are dying. Then there's one more practice. Okay, this practice is associated with Omkara. It's called Bija Mantra Dhyana. So this has to be done when you are going to sleep. Okay. So the Bija Mantra or Omkara is put in various parts of your body. Okay, you have to just listen to audio and go to sleep. Okay, as the Bija Mantra penetrates each and every cell of your body and starts purifying you from internally. Okay, internal purification happens. Because we are actually, our body and mind is so much exposed to the society and mind, it requires purification. This is called mantra snana. So that you can do only when you are going to sleep. Just listen to that and go to sleep. As you do that, you start feeling deeper peace because the body mind complex gets purified. So this is about Omkara Dhyana. Bija Mantra Dhyana, I'll share it in the app. All of you are able to download the app. So in that app, the Bija Mantra Dhyana will be there, and all this class also will be there so that you can refer. Okay. Right? So the Bija Mantra Dhyana is just put it and go to sleep and do it every day. There's a deep transformation happens in your life. Simply listening to that. Okay. The mind becomes calm, the health improves because there's a purification takes place. It's called Omkara Dhyana. Any questions on this? Any questions for people who are online? You can ask. Either through chat or audio, you can ask. Okay. So now we'll go to other mantra. There's a specific purpose for choosing these mantras. The Omkara is considered the highest and greatest mantra. Okay. It is Saguna Brahma and Nirguna Brahma mantra. Then there is a mantra. What is this mantra do? What does mantra do? Is our consciousness is like an ocean. You can see, right? There are waves. In the ocean, there are a lot of waves at the surface level because the wind is there. But as you go deeper and deeper into the ocean, what will happen to you? It is very, very silent, very deep stillness. Okay, absolute stillness. The waves are our mind. Okay. The wind is our prana. And what you see outside is the world. There's a lot of turbulence with our mind because sense organs and mind is exposed to the world. Okay. The dhyana or meditation means go inwards. Silently into our consciousness. Basically, our mind has to become progressive like that. So for that, some amount of purification is required. And that purification happens through Namasmarana, Omkara Dhyana, and other mantras. Because the mind is still so impure. Okay, that's called Chitta Shuddhi. Dhyana, japa will help you, chitta shuddhi. So then gradually you'll be sink, able to sink into deeper and deeper. When you go deeper and deeper, okay, the mind becomes more and more silent. And that's where we call, whatever we call as devatas are there in that. Actually, devatas are not outside. They are as a deeper part of consciousness. Okay. When you touch the deepest level of your consciousness, it's called Narayan. Okay, Narayan. It's total silence, total stillness. That's called Mukti Dhamma, Parandhamma. It's not a physical place. It is a place in your consciousness. But the mind has to be silent and reach there. And what is the vehicle for reaching there? Is mantra. So as you chant mantra, and especially the mantra, Bija Mantra Dhyana, when you do, going to sleep, that will purify you and will take you to deeper and deeper level of consciousness without much effort. Okay. So this will take you deeper and deeper level. And the deepest level of your consciousness is called Narayana. And it's called Sadashiva or Shiva. So now, you cannot separate out wave and ocean. It's all one. We are waves. Okay? But we think we are separate. But really, we are part of the ocean. The ocean is called Vishnu. The infinity ocean. Vishwam, Vishnu, Vashatkaro. The whole universe is Vishnu. The ocean is Vishnu. We are like waves. But we have to stop being waves and we start merging with the water. Go deeper and deeper into consciousness. And that is called Nididhyasa. Okay. So the help purification process is called mantra, holy name, Pavitra Nam. Okay, any questions? So there are two namas, two names we have been chant. Okay. One is Krishna Nama and another is called Krishna Nama, Rama Nama, all Vishnu's avatars. They are related. Krishna is Mayadisha. Vishnu is Mayadisha. He is the one who protects in the world. Okay. Shiva is Adiguru. He destroys the Maya. He pulls you inwards. And Narayana protects you. Shiva, Vishnu protects you in the Vishnu and Rama's avatar protects you. That's why all avatars are Vishnu avatar. So in the Maya world, you have to be protected by Krishna mantra. Jnana, we have to be protected by Shiva. Shiva is for Dhyana. Vishnu is for, when I am operating in the world, I should be protected by from Maya. That's Vishnu mantra. That's why two mantras. And then you have your Ishtadevata mantra. I'll tell you each of you what is your Ishtadevata mantra and why it is so, that we'll take in the future classes. So when you chant the mantra, okay, you can chant the mantra in three centers. This center and this center, you can chant. So when you chant in this center, deeper love gets awakened. Don't have to visualize form. Just chant mantra, because mantra itself is divine energy. Okay, because we start struggling, God should be this form and all. The energy itself starts taking the form of love. Peace. Okay. So that is the experience of God. So let us chant here now, in this center. So this is called Hare Krishna mantra. So Hare Krishna is, Krishna is the protector in the Maya. He is the Maya Adhipati. Have you heard of Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada?
Yeah.
You heard a story?
He's the ISKCON founder.
I'll tell you the story. Mm-hmm. So he was a householder. He was running a printing press. And he used to have a newsletter called Back to Godhead. That time Second World War was happening. He was feeling that people have to think of Krishna. Then only they get peace. The world war happening, many people are dying. But his paper was not getting sold. Gradually, at some time, he became monk. At the age of 70, he became monk, 68. His guru told him that you go and teach about Krishna in the Western society. So, to go to Western society, he is an old man. He got a see it in Sindhya navigation ship. Sindhya navigation ship. It's not a passenger ship. It's a goods shop, goods ship. Goods are there. And he said, and in the ship, he got 2 times heart attack. Okay. But his guru has told him to go to teach Krishna. He just kept on chanting Krishna mantra and he landed in New York. In New York, he doesn't know anybody. And in New York, he went to Times Square. Times Square is a, like a crowded, is a center of the New York. And who will care for a person who is a saffron class? He didn't have any money in his pocket. But he had only one thing. Krishna mantra. He chanted that mantra. Just kept on chanting. Then people started gathering around. They also started chanting. At that time, America was going through hippie movement. A lot of people are drug addicts. So they were actually children, because father and mother were working, the children are not taken care of. The children have become drug addicts. American government was spending millions of dollars for people, curing the people from drug addiction. These people saw something strange. This guy is chanting Hare Krishna mantra. They didn't know what's the mantra. They also liked it, the way it's chanting. They started chanting. Medicine will cure you, even if you don't know what is that in that. Just by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, within few days, all of them became free from drug addiction. Okay? They didn't know what is Krishna. They just don't know what is mantra. Just by chanting. They just like it, chant it. And within few days, many of them became so pure. They said, I want to become a monk. They don't know what is monk also. Many of them in monk. This is at the age of 70. Okay? Between this age of 70 and 74, and 108 Krishna temples were opened worldwide. Where is this old man of 70 years? And thousands of people or lakhs of people started Krishna's name. People started chanting Krishna's name and dancing in the streets of Moscow. And people started becoming vegetarians. Stop. They don't know what is Krishna. They don't know anything. This is the purifying effect of mantra. That's why mantra is holy name, Pavitra Nama. We wrote it very casually. We don't even understand the power of the mantra. The mantra itself, chanting itself will purify us. And chant with the family, the whole family gets purified. Chant in a place, the place gets purified. The people started doing Ratayatra. We are not aware of this thing. Ratayatra in Moscow, Ratayatra in China, Ratayatra in this thing. People started chanting the purifying effect of consciousness. You don't have to know the name of Krishna. You don't know what is Krishna is. The mantra itself, you don't know what dress Krishna wears. Just mantra vibration will be beautiful. It's Omkara as highest vibration. Then Hare Krishna. Then one more thing I will tell you about Hare Krishna. In India, the Islam was spreading and any practice of Hindus was banned. Anybody who practiced Hinduism was either killed or converted. West Bengal was full of Muslim people. At that time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. No puja can be done. He just stood in the street and started Krishna movement, Krishna japa. People started joining. It became mass movement. It spread like anything. Nobody could control. Otherwise, everything all our dharma would have been died. Just because of mantra bala, it got revived. Okay. Let us chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Your attention should be here. Okay. Don't have to imagine anything. Just Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Rama Rama.
Rama Rama.
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Become aware of your heart center.
asatoma
asatoma
sadgamaya
sadgamaya
tamasoma
tamasoma
jyotirgamaya
jyotirgamaya
mrityorma
mrityorma
amritam gamaya
amritam gamaya
om shanti shanti shantih
om shanti shanti shantih
लोकाः समस्ताः
लोकाः समस्ताः
सुखिनो भवन्तु
सुखिनो भवन्तु
लोकाः समस्ताः
लोकाः समस्ताः
सुखिनो भवन्तु
सुखिनो भवन्तु
हरिः ॐ
हरिः ॐ
श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः
श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः
हरिः ॐ So this is the mantra for protecting us in the world, because Vishnu and Narayana Krishna are in the control of consciousness, is in the control of the Maya, and Shiva is Adiguru, he is the controller of Mukti, Jnana. Okay, so Om Namah Shivaya mantra. Om stands for, I already told, there are more meanings to Om. Na means earth, Ma means Vayu, She means fire, Va means wind, Ya means space. Entire universe is manifestation of Shiva in the form of Shakti. Okay. Shiva is the silence, Om. So Om Namah Shivaya mantra is for the dhyana. Our mind becomes more and more inwards. Vishnu mantra, Narayana mantra protects us, purifies us. Om Namah Shivaya mantra takes us inwards. Okay, today we don't have much time. I'll just quickly tell Om Namah Shivaya mantra. Okay. Om Namah Shivaya. Again, your heart, the center, here. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah O.
Shivaya Namah O.
Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah O.
Shivaya Namah O.
Shivaya Namah O.
Shivaya Namah O.
Asatoma
asatoma
sadgamaya
sadgamaya
tamasoma
tamasoma
jyotirgamaya
jyotirgamaya
mrityorma
mrityorma
amritam gamaya
amritam gamaya
om shanti shanti shantih
om shanti shanti shantih
lokaah samastaah
lokaah samastaah
sukhino bhavantu
sukhino bhavantu
lokaah samastaah
lokaah samastaah
sukhino bhavantu
sukhino bhavantu
lokaah samastaah
lokaah samastaah
sukhino bhavantu
sukhino bhavantu
finally Narayana mantra. Narayana is the innermost consciousness. Once you touch Narayana consciousness, you are liberated. Mukti. Jiva Mukti. Mind has to go deeper and deeper to Narayana consciousness.
There is a small story behind this. Ramanujacharya. There are three great acharyas: Shankaracharya, Madhvacharya, Ramanujacharya. Is great teachers. So Ramanujacharya was the guru. He was learning under master guru, and guru told him this Narayana mantra and told him he should not tell anybody. So the purpose is, the mantra is always should be learned from a guru, because that energy gets transferred. Anything has to be learned from a guru. The energy gets transferred. It's not just a learning, it is something more happens in that. So then Ramanujacharya asked, what happens if this mantra is told to somebody? Anybody who chants Narayana mantra and touches that Narayana consciousness, they will be going to Mukti Vaikuntha. Then what if what happens if I tell? So if you tell without my permission, you will go to hell. You're not supposed to tell. So Ramanujacharya immediately ran to the center of the city. In the city, there was a small hill. He stood on the top of the hill and called everybody. There is a very special mantra. Anybody wants to get to Mukti, you can chant this mantra. Om Namo,
Om Namo
Narayana,
Narayana,
Om Namo,
Om Namo
Narayana,
Narayana,
Om Namo,
Om Namo
Narayana,
Narayana,
Om Namo,
Om Namo
Narayana. Chanting the mantra without my permission. Ramanujacharya said, if many people can go to Mukti, I'm going to ready to go to hell. Such is the compassion of like Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Shankaracharya, many rishis have done a lot of Nara teaching to us. Unfortunately, we have forgotten. As a service to all these gurus, and offering my little bit yadna in the form of this class. May all gurus be pleased with whatever you have done. May bless us with the Nana Bhakti Vairagya. Jyot se jyot jagao,
jyot se jyot jagao,
sadguru jyot se jyot jagao,
sadguru jyot se jyot jagao,
mera antar timira mitao,
timira mitao,
Guru Jyot se Jyot jagao,
Sadguru Jyot se Jyot jagao,
Hey Yogeshwar, Hey Jnaneshwar,
Hey Sarveshwar,
Hey Parameshwar,
Hey Parameshwar,
Nija Kripa Barsavo, Sadguru Jyot se Jyot jagao,
Sadguru Jyot se Jyot jagao,
Jyot se Jyot jagao,
Jyot se Jyot jagao,
Sadguru Jyot se Jyot jagao,
Sadguru Jyot se Jyot jagao,
Mera antar
ಮಿಟಾವು
ಇಂದ್ರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು ಹಮ ಬಾಲಕ
ತೇರೆ ದ್ವಾರ ಪೆ ಆಯೆ
ತೇರೆ ದ್ವಾರ ಪೆ ಆಯೆ ಹಮ ಬಾಲಕ
ತೇರೆ ದ್ವಾರ ಪೆ ಆಯೆ
ತೇರೆ ದ್ವಾರ ಪೆ ಆಯೆ
ಮಂಗಳ ದರಸ ದಿಖಾವೋ
ಮಂಗಳ ದರಸ ದಿಖಾವೋ
ಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಮೇರಾ ಅಂತರ ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಶೀಶ ಜುಕಾಯೆ
ಶೀಶ ಜುಕಾಯೆ
ಕರೇ ತೇರಿ ಆರತಿ
ಕರೇ ತೇರಿ ಆರತಿ
ಶೀಶ ಜುಕಾಯೆ
ಶೀಶ ಜುಕಾಯೆ
ಕರೇ ತೇರಿ ಆರತಿ
ಕರೇ ತೇರಿ ಆರತಿ
ಪ್ರೇಮ ಸುಧಾ ಬರಸಾವು
ಪ್ರೇಮ ಸುಧಾ ಬರಸಾವು
ಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಮೇರಾ ಅಂತರ ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಅಂತರ ಮೇ ಯುಗ
ಅಂತರ ಮೇ ಯುಗ
ಯುಗ ಸೆ ಸೋಯಿ
ಯುಗ ಸೆ ಸೋಯಿ
ಅಂತರ ಮೇ ಯುಗ
ಅಂತರ ಮೇ ಯುಗ
ಯುಗ ಸೆ ಸೋಯಿ
ಯುಗ ಸೆ ಸೋಯಿ
ಚತಿ ಚಿತಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೋ ಜಗಾವೋ
ಚಿತಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೋ ಜಗಾವೋ
ಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಮೇರಾ ಅಂತರ ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸಚ್ಚಿ ಜ್ಯೋತ
ಸಚ್ಚಿ ಜ್ಯೋತ
ಜಗೇ ಹೃದಯ ಮೇ ಸಚ್ಚಿ ಜ್ಯೋತ
ಸಚ್ಚಿ ಜ್ಯೋತ
ಜಗೇ ಹೃದಯ ಮೇ
ಸೋಹಮನಾದ
ಜಗಾವು
ಸೋಹಮನಾದ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಮೇರಾ ಅಂತರ ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಜೀವನ ಆತ್ಮ
ಆನಂದ ಅವಿನಾಶಿ
ಶರಣನ ಶರಣ ಲಗಾವು ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಅಂತರ ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ತಿಮಿರ ಮಿಟಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
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 ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಸದಗುರು ಜ್ಯೋತ ಸೆ ಜ್ಯೋತ ಜಗಾವು
ಮೇರಾ ಅಂತರ
Sadguru Jyot Se Jyot Jagao
Sadguru Jyot Se Jyot Jagao
Mano Buddhi
Ahankar
Chittani Naham
Na Cha Shrotra Jivve
Na Cha Grana Netre Na Cha Vyoma
Bhumirna
Tejo Na Vayu
Chidananda Rupah
Shivoham I am not
The mind
Intellect
Ego
Or memory
I am not
Five organs
Of knowledge
I am not
Five elements
I am pure consciousness
Shivasurupi
Na cha prana sanno
Na vai panchavayuhu
I am not
Five pranas
Or five vital airs
Navasaptadatuhu
Navapanchakoshaha Navatpanipadam
Na cha upastapayuhu
Chidananda Rupah
Shivoham
I am not
Seven elements
Or five layers of body
I am not
Five organs
Of action
I am pure consciousness
Shivasurupi
Name Dvesha Ragau
Name Lobha Mohau
Attraction
and repulsion
Do not touch me
Name Vai
Madonaiva
Matsaryabhavaha
Na Dharmo
Na Artho
Na Kamo
Na Mokshaha
Chidananda Rupah
Shivoham
Shivoham
I am not affected
By jealousy
Or hatred
Dharma
Artha
Kama
Moksha
Are not for me
Chidananda Rupah
Shivoham
Shivoham
I am pure consciousness
Shivasvarupi
Nacha
Sangam
Namuktirnameha
Chidananda Rupah
Shivoham
Shivoham
Pure consciousness
Shivasvarupi
Na punyam
Na punyam
Na papam
Na saukhyam
Na dukham
Na mantro
Na mantro
Na tirtham
Na veda
Na veda
Na yajna
Good merit
And sin
Happiness
And unhappiness
Are not for me.
Mantra and Tirtha.
Are not for me.
I am pure consciousness.
Shivasvarupi.
Aham.
Bhojanam.
Naiva bhojyam.
Na bhokta.
Chidananda Rupah.
Shivoham.
Shivoham.
Name Mrityu.
Name Mrityu.
Shanka.
Name.
Jati Beda.
Pitanaiva.
Menaiva.
Matana Janmaha.
Chidananda Rupah.
Shivoham.
Shivoham.
I am not.
The experiencer.
Or experienced.
I don't have birth.
Death.
Bondage.
Or liberation.
I am pure consciousness. I am pure consciousness.
Shivasvarupi.
Shivasvarupi. Asatoma.
Asatoma.
Sadgamaya.
Sadgamaya.
Tamasoma.
Tamasoma.
Jyotirgamaya.
Jyotirgamaya.
Mrityorma.
Mrityorma.
Amritam gamaya.
Amritam gamaya.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Lokaha samastaha.
Lokaha samastaha.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Lokaha samastaha.
Lokaha samastaha.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Lokaha samastaha.
Lokaha samastaha.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Harihi om.
Harihi om.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Harihi om.
Harihi om.
With this, we are concluding the class for today. You can take our prasadam and have lunch.